We welcome you to Campbell's Field, the site of Bridgeport Bluefish Baseball on BridgeportBluefish.com. The Bluefish about to take on the Camden Riversharks in a run to a potential postseason berth. Hello, everyone. The Bluefish come off of a disappointing loss yesterday. The Bluefish put their best efforts forward. In the end, it wound up as a 3-2 loss, one that the Camden Riversharks, they were able to overcome the final game of the series against the Southern Maryland Bluecrafts. So two teams having opposite results yesterday, and the Bluefish are hoping that they can provide much, much better performance over this series against Camden. They know that the Bluefish need to make up a couple of games against the Bluecrafts before heading into that pivotal series at the ballpark at Harbor Yard. The Bluefish come in with a record today of 56 wins and 66 losses. They are one game behind the Camden Riversharks for overall record, but the Bluefish are 2.5 in front of Camden for the second half standings, which matters more because there's a big difference between the wild card leading York Revolution and the Camden Riversharks with respect to the Bluefish and how much they're trailing Southern Maryland by. Today's starting lineups include Matt Pike on the hill for the Bluefish. The right-hander goes up against Brian Corey, the longtime veteran of Big League Baseball and Triple-A Baseball. Righty versus righty today. Pike this season, 2 wins and 8 losses, an ERA north of 6 against Brian Corey, who has a record of 8 wins and 9 losses with an ERA of 5.78. The righties will match up tonight from Campbell's Field. When we come back on Bluefish Broadcast Network, we're going to have several interview segments. Brad Thompson, Brad Boyer, B-Squared interviews coming up, but we'll introduce you to those two, then it's off to the starting lineups and off to first pitch from Campbell's Field in Southern New Jersey. You're listening to Bluefish Baseball on BridgeportBluefish.com.
Great tasting Miller Lite. You're choosing on taste, and that's the right choice, not the wrong choice, because right is way better than wrong. You don't try to do the wrong thing.
In assessing where the team is at this moment, hear what he has to say.
Next, ladies and gentlemen, my pleasure to introduce to you right now. I kept looking up at the board and seeing everybody on their teams hitting 330.
Oh, boy.
Yeah, pretty impressive over there. But, we played some good games against them. And like you said, we could have, taken that series easily. But, a couple things didn't go our way. But, here we are. We're in Camden now. We're going to win some games and, figure it out.
That was Brad Thompson on the assessment of the team. But Brad Boyer had a completely different angle. He knew what happened last night. He took a couple of good swings against Tim Hamulak and could not get a hit against the left-handed closer of the Barnstormers. Here's what Boyer had to say about Tim Hamulak and his performance last night.
Yeah, facing a guy like that, especially since I've been over there before when I played with them earlier, and the guy's really tough, not just against lefties, but righties as well. And I knew, going into that AB, the guy's got a 90, 92 plus mile an hour fastball, great off speed, and basically, as a left-handed hitter, you want to stay on that ball as long as you can. And going in that AB, I saw two sliders. I saw, fastballs on the outer half. And, it was unfortunate I wasn't able to get him. He made some really good pitches on me.
Certainly, Boyer first faced some issues during that at-bat. But the Bluefish wound up losing last night by a score of 3-2 in Lancaster. 140-game season is something that most baseball fans will never understand, the kind of physical grind that someone goes through, especially one likes a Brad Thompson, who had Tommy John surgery before the season began and made his way back for this year. He had Tommy John in 2011 trying to make his way back, was in Double-A for a short period of time this year, but wound up in the Freedom Pro League. Here is Thompson on the grind coming back from injury.
No, I haven't heard anything from anybody. But for me, I'm happy being here right now, and I'm, getting my work in. That's the plan right now. I'm at a point where, overall, with my few stops I've had this year, my first time probably in about 5 or 6 years that I'm over 100 innings now. So for me, it's getting in the work and, getting my arm, you know, prepared for another year next year.
You briefly mentioned about the 100 innings. Is your arm beginning to feel it because you haven't done it in that long?
Oh, yeah, it's definitely. I mean, I can definitely tell that I'm, you know, getting a little tired as the year goes on. But that's normal. You know, that happens. Everybody goes through the grind. And now it's just knowing when to save your bullets. And, you know, like today, I don't think I'm going to touch a baseball today. You know, have a nice day off. But yeah, it's part of the season, part of the grind, and you know, this is my first year starting for a whole year also.
Brad Thompson, first year starting, first year that he's thrown more than 100 innings in six seasons. He was in the big leagues mostly as a relief pitcher. Occasionally he did start, but this is uncharted waters for Brad Thompson and company, especially with the kind of players that have been trying to recover from injury. The likes of a Brad Thompson. You also have quite a few other players who are recovering from injury. Paul Seguero with the hamstring, Matt Pike with the fatigue arm. Every single one of the players are pushing themselves to the limit this year to try to get the Bluefish their first championship since 1999. As far as Brad Boyer is concerned, he loves the way that the team played. He understands how great these teams are. At the same time, he knows every night he has a chance, and his team has a chance to win the game.
Well, I mean, you know, anybody can beat anybody on any given day. It's when you go out there and take the field, you give it your all, and you show that competitive fire. And you saw the resilience out of our team coming out there, you know, during that series. It's unfortunate last night we weren't able to get a W, but just showing, you know, the way we played during that anything's possible, you know, the next couple weeks.
The next couple of weeks are going to determine whether or not the Bluefish make it to the postseason. The Bluefish start with a four-game series tonight against the Riversharks. They'll follow up with a 10-game homestand, Southern Maryland, Sugar Land for four, and Lancaster for three, followed up by a Somerset three-game series to wrap up the season, unless that final game, the one that was canceled or postponed due to inclement weather, needs to be made up between the Bluefish and the Long Island Ducks. The Bluefish are hoping they will not have to play that game, that they'll be a game and a half ahead of Southern Maryland by the time that comes up, either a game and a half ahead of Southern Maryland or a game and a half ahead of the rest of the competition for the wild card. The Bluefish starting lineup presented by BridgeportBluefish.com. Kennard Jones leads off. It's the first time that he's led off in more than a week. He's playing left field. Eddie Rogers is the shortstop batting second. Prentice Redmond's in right field batting third, while Willis Otañez is the DH batting fourth. Luis Lopez is batting fifth and playing first base. James Simmons is in center field batting sixth. Brad Boyer is the third baseman batting seventh. Luis Figueroa is the second baseman batting eighth. And Angel Flores rounds out the rotation for the Bluefish as Matt Pike makes his way to the hill. He's been pitching a little bit better of late, but he's had a little bit of shoulder fatigue throughout the course of the season. He's been shuffling between starting rotation, then the bullpen. Once he got a little bit of fatigue, he was on the disabled list or the inactive list for a little bit. He took a couple of starts off, got back to the team as a relief pitcher, worked his way back because he improved to starting rotation, then back into the bullpen, back into the starting rotation. It's difficult to perform well when you're in those different roles, shuffled back and forth. You never know when you're going to throw. It seems that the best remedy for Pike, not knowing when he's throwing, when he's thrown every fifth day and known that he's throwing every fifth day this year, he seems to have struggled a little bit. Whereas when he's thrown into the fire right away, saw his best performance of the year a few weeks back, 5 2/3 innings of two-run baseball. This year, Pike, 2 wins and 8 losses, an ERA north of 6 at 6.14. Fastball, slider, changeup, occasional breaking balls, a variety of six different pitches, the two-seam, the four-seam, variations of those offerings that he'll throw today. Brian Corey is on the hill for the River Sharks. He is a veteran of AAA and Major League Baseball. He has more than a decade and a half of service between AAA and the big leagues, and that's where he spent most of his career. Corey, 23 games this season, 8-9 with an ERA of 5.78. Fastball, changeup, and curveball. The Bluefish faced him a couple of times this year. Corey, about a .500 pitcher against the Bluefish in 2012. Reed Gorecki, the former Long Island Duck, was traded to the River Sharks a few weeks back. He's in center field leading off. Chris Walker is in left field batting second. Brian Burgamy rounds out the outfield rotation in right field batting third. Pedro Feliz is at third base batting fourth, while Raul Padron is doing the catching batting fifth. Eduardo Perez, brought in mostly for his bat, not necessarily for his glove, is at first base batting sixth. Alvin Colina, the designated hitter, batting seventh. Jake Eigesti is the shortstop batting eighth, and former big leaguer Delwin Young rounds out the rotation. He plays second base and bats ninth for the River Sharks. The Bluefish right now 2.5 games ahead of the River Sharks in the division for second place, but numero uno belongs to Southern Maryland. That team has run away with the division to this point. Will the Bluefish be able to make up enough ground to force either a play-in game or force themselves into the postseason? Luis Lopez said to me on the side before, his team is ready. He knows that his team needs to make up two games in this weekend set, which means York needs to take care of business against Southern Maryland at Regency Furniture Stadium, a ballpark in which York has struggled against Southern Maryland, and Southern Maryland has done very well this season. The umpiring crew for tonight's contest: Eric Diaz is behind the plate calling the balls and the strikes. Matt Beaver is over at first base, and the third base umpire is Bill Reeder. When we come back on BridgeportBluefish.com, Atlantic League News update time and first pitch from Campbell's Field. You're listening to Bluefish Baseball on BridgeportBluefish.com.
The YP.com website is your local search engine. If you're looking for a good restaurant, it can help you find the right one nearby with ratings and reviews. Or if your car breaks down, you can use the YP app to find the closest repair shop. Or maybe you're just looking for something to do on a Friday night. Well, it has great local coupons for all sorts of things in your area. No matter what, when, or where, if you're looking for something, YP Local Search can help you find it. So go to YP.com or download the app to search local, find local, and save local.
The Gear Shop at the ballpark at Harbor Yard is your one-stop shop for everything Bluefish. Take a break from the action and check out all your Bluefish souvenir favorites. From men's and women's t-shirts and a wide selection of home, road, and other trendy hats, to Fear the Fin rally towels, team photos, and commemorative baseballs. The Gear Shop has it all. Don't forget about our kids' wear section, game-worn jerseys, even your own stuffed BB the Bluefish, and more. The Bluefish Gear Shop is located on the third base side of the concourse level at the ballpark at Harbor Yard and is open on game days. Come and browse all your favorite Bluefish apparel from an hour before the first pitch until the final out is made. Can't make it to the ballpark on game day but still want to support Fairfield County's only professional baseball team? Then check out the new Bluefish online store at BridgeportBluefish.com or call 203-345-4800 to schedule an appointment. The Bluefish Gear Shop. Perfect gifts for all ages and all sizes. Located at the ballpark at Harbor Yard, 500 Main Street, Bridgeport, Connecticut.
You know what sounds really great for lunch? Breakfast. And what would be awesome for dinner? Breakfast. See, there's no better choice for breakfast, lunch, or dinner than Chips. Chips Family Restaurants in Orange and Fairfield. Known far and wide for extreme acts of outrageous pancakery, Chips also has a lunch and dinner menu that'll have you ditching the drive-thru and saying bye-bye brown bag. A full lunch and dinner menu of outrageously delicious sandwiches, salads, steaks, reasonably priced. And, of course, Chips' famous pancakes for any meal, any day. For breakfast, lunch, or dinner, flip it to Chips on the Post Road in Orange and in Fairfield at the intersection of Black Rock Turnpike and Tunxas Hill Cutoff. Voted best in Connecticut by the readers of Connecticut Magazine for extreme acts of outrageous pancakery all day long.
When you choose a great-tasting Miller Lite, you're choosing on taste. And that's the right choice, not the wrong choice. Because right is way better than wrong. You don't try to do the wrong thing. Got a wrong hand man? I've got a cousin named Randall with clammy hands. The customer's always wrong? Well, that explains the waiter's creepy grin as I ate my toast. Two wrongs do make a wrong. So make the right choice and choose on taste. Triple Hops Brewed Miller Lite. Taste greatness. Miller Brewing Company, Milwaukee, Wisconsin. Great beer, great responsibility. At Miller Lite, we believe that sharing a pitcher of our great-tasting draft beer will bring friends together for a good time. And good is way better than bad. No one reminisces about the bad old days. If your guess is as bad as mine, then we're a couple of idiot faces. So far, so bad? Turn that frown upside down, Grumpy Pants. So why have a bad time when you could have a good time with a pitcher of Miller Lite draft beer? Triple Hops Brewed Miller Lite. Taste greatness. Miller Brewing Company, Milwaukee, Wisconsin. Great beer, great responsibility. At Miller Lite, we know there's only one thing baseball fans love as much as great Pilsner taste, and that's rooting for the home team. Because home is way better than away. Away is not where the heart is. Bringing away the bacon? Why? Bacon is delicious. Away is where you hang your hat? You should be hung up by your underpanties. So why root for the away team when you can root for the home team? With a great Pilsner taste of Miller Lite. Triple Hops Brewed Miller Lite. Taste greatness. Miller Brewing Company, Milwaukee, Wisconsin. Great beer, great responsibility.
Welcome you back to the Bluefish Broadcast Network. Perry Miles with you as the Bluefish are about to take on the Camden Riversharks. An excellent rendition of the national anthem just performed. Behind home plate towards the right side. The Bluefish and the Riversharks are ready. The Bluefish going to be wearing their road gray uniforms today. The Riversharks in their home whites and reds. Oh, symbolic of that of the Philadelphia Phillies, which is just so happens to be the team, the major league squad right across the river, about 10 minutes away. And the right-handed pitcher who's been in the big leagues for quite a while is right-handed pitcher Brian Corey. He has been in Major League Baseball. He's been in AAA Baseball. He's done a solid job thus far giving Camden innings out of the starting rotation. His numbers quite high though. 8 wins and 9 losses and ERA well above 5. And the right-handed pitcher is going to feature a fastball. He's going to also feature a changeup, a slider, and a curveball. 4 pitches that he'll be able to use for strikes as Corey releases the final warm-up pitch. And we are underway from Campbell's Field. The right-handed pitcher of late has not lasted as long as what he did initially. Many of the pitchers are getting a bit exhausted out there, and that goes with the wear and tear, the fatigue of the season. Brad Thompson explained once he's going over 100 innings, his arm begins to feel it because he was accustomed to going in the bullpen. And same way with many of the other pitchers, which include the likes of Eddie Camacho, who was a bullpen guy for much of his Camden career and now is in the starting rotation. The first pitch is planted on the inside corner to Kennard Jones. No balls and 1 strike. It is Jones, Eddie Rogers, and Prentice Redmond due up as the right-hander Corey delivers. The pitch is spiked to the dirt. 1 ball and 1 strike. Jones on the year at 265. He does not have a home run to this point, and he's had 46 runs batted in. Last series, had 1 outstanding game, 3-for-4, 3 runs, including a game-changing infield singles. The pitch is lofted to short and grabbed by Agosti, 1 away. It's an L6 for Jones as Eddie Rogers steps up to the plate. That infield single resulted in a 5-4 game going to 5-5, and Luis Rodriguez poked a home run to right field to make it 7-5. He doesn't beat that single out. It's 5-4 heading into the ninth inning minimum because the bottom of the frame came up for Lancaster. Eddie Rogers digs in. Rogers has been much better of late. He's been batting in the leadoff spot today. He's batting in the two hole It's the first time in more than a week that he has done that. On the year at 269, as the first pitch dances outside, the count one ball and no strikes. Chris Walker, Reed Gorecki, Brian Burgamy from left to right in the outfield, Pedro Feliz and Jake Igesti on the left side of the infield as the pitch is popped up behind the plate, close to the broadcast booth, and it falls five rows in front, and a lucky fan comes away with the baseball and a youngster irate about not getting the ball.
I just said watch, you might get a ball back.
One ball and one strike. With one man out, top of the first inning, no score. You have Delwin Young and Eduardo Perez on the right side of the infield. The pitch is planted outside. Two balls and one strike. Second and first. Raul Padron is behind the plate. He is not the better defensive catcher, but Alvin Colina has been as the pitch is lifted down the left field line, but it goes well foul. Count at two balls and two strikes. We thank everybody for tuning in to the Bluefish broadcast. This is the video stream on BridgeportBluefish.com. You can see plenty of the infield. Equidistant dimensions in this ballpark. 325, 365, and 405 to the lines, to the alleys, and to center. Pitch lofted foul to the right. Two balls, two strikes. The wind is going to help the right-handed batters substantially tonight compared with lefties who deal with the jet stream more often at this ball field. The wind angled more towards left center as the pitch is lined foul down the left side. Rogers staying alive, two balls and two strikes. Eddie Rogers started out the year batting towards the bottom of the order. Rogers, a Bluefish player in 2009 before he was picked up, was in Double-A and Triple-A baseball for quite a while. Rogers' improvement based on the influence of Shea Hillenbrand no longer with the team. The 2-2 is sent in the air to shallow left center field. Jogging forward, Reed Gorecki, he settles underneath and makes the play for the second out of the frame. The center fielder Gorecki. It is an F8 as Prentice Redmond digs in. Shea Hillenbrand left the team for undisclosed reasons. And we wish nothing but the best from here on out. There were quite a few players who had left the team. The two out tosses on the inside corner, 0-1. Dan Serafini for personal reasons. Juan Rincon for personal reasons. The 0-1 dances inside. One ball and one strike on a backdoor breaking ball. Prentice Redmond, one of the league's leaders in doubles. He's on pace to tie Wes Bankston for the most doubles in Bluefish history. The next toss is on the inside corner for a strike, a ball and two strikes. Bankston had 39 doubles last season. And this year, Redmond is projected to hit 39. One ball, two strikes. Corey delivers. Pitch is jammed foul to the left. Count remains at a ball and two strikes. Corey's pitch count tends to get high. Very high at times. We do apologize for any technical difficulties that we may experience during the broadcast. The internet stream as the pitch is chopped on the ground towards short. Igesti gathers and throws to first to retire the side. The Bluefish do not score in the first inning. It's a 1-2-3. At the end of a half, no score from Campbell's. You're listening to Bluefish Baseball on BridgeportBluefish.com. We'll be right back. The Bluefish have great gifts and giveaways coming up at the ballpark at Harbor Yard, beginning with a series against the Southern Maryland Blue Crabs on September 11th. That Tuesday is Kids Eat Free, presented by Big Y World Class Market. Kids 12 and under are entitled to a hot dog, potato chips, and a fountain beverage. Wednesday is Bark in the Park Night, presented by Canine Company, followed by Thirsty Thursday, presented by Budweiser. Friday the 14th kicks off Fan Appreciation Weekend with a fireworks extravaganza presented by Sabrette. 7:05 first pitch for each game during the week. Saturday the 15th features 2 7-inning games as part of a doubleheader beginning at 1 p.m. from Bridgeport. Race Pass giveaway is sponsored by Grand Prix of New York. Sunday is all about family fun, as there is a kids' autograph session before the game and kids run the bases afterwards.
the 2:05 first pitch on Sunday, with gates opening 1 hour before each first pitch. Tickets are available for the series by going to BridgeportBluefish.com or by calling 203-345-4800. Bridgeport Bluefish Baseball. Get hooked.
At Miller Lite, we believe if you're not choosing a light beer with more taste, you need to man up, not man down. Because up is way better than down. You don't tell someone sad to cheer down. What's down, dog? A steamy pile and you just stepped in it. Your girlfriend's not wearing a push-down bra. It's called gravity, Isaac Nitwit. Can I be down front with you? All this down talk is bringing me down. So don't man down, man up, and choose a light beer with more taste. Triple Hops Brewed Miller Lite. Taste greatness. Miller Brewing Company, Milwaukee, Wisconsin. Great beer, great responsibility.
The Bluefish Broadcast Network is back. Perry Miles with you. The man on the mound for the Bluefish is Matt Pike, the right-handed pitcher on the year with a record of 2 wins and 8 losses, an ERA of above 6. The right-handed pitcher will be taking on Reed Gorecki, Chris Walker, and Brian Bergamy, 1, 2, and 3 in the order. Gorecki was a former member of the Ducks. He was an outfielder and was starting often, but found himself on the outside of the fold. 275, 10 homers, and 46 RBI on the year for the right-handed batter out of Long Island, New York. Gorecki, his dad actually taught at my alma mater, and he attended a school out in Long Island. I believe it's called Kellenberg High School. As the first pitch from Pike lands over the middle of the plate, no balls and one strike. The alma mater, Cardozo High School. That's where his dad had taught for a number of years. Now is the baseball coach over there. The 0-1 is sent in the air to deep center field. Moving back is James Simmons. He corrals towards the warning track for the first out of the frame. The ball tends to travel much better in this ballpark than any of the equidistant, equidimensional ballparks in this league. Long Island, Bridgeport, Camden, and that's it. Those are the only ones that have the same dimensions linearly from right field to center and left field to center out. The Bluefish record the first out on the F8 as Chris Walker digs in. He's at 238 on the year, driven 11 out of the park, knocked in 40. First pitch, fastball is outside, 1 ball and no strikes. The problem with Pike this year, it's not his inability to throw the strikes. He's thrown plenty of those. Where those strikes are located, and batters are taking advantage. The 1-0 planted on the inside corner, 1 ball and 1 strike. Angel Flores is starting behind the plate tonight. Brad Boyer's over at third base. Eddie Rogers at short. Luis Figueroa and Luis Lopez second and first. The 1-1, fastball tucked outside, 2 balls and 1 strike. Jones, Simmons, and Prentice Redmond left to right in the outfield tonight. It is a hot and humid day just across the river from Philadelphia. The 2-1, slap foul down the left side, 2 balls and 2 strikes. The place that Pike knows very well, other than Bridgeport, is Camden, because Pike, first time in the Atlantic League, was with the Riversharks. At one point, once he left the Riversharks for the Bluefish in 08, before the 08 season, Pike had played the outfield because the Bluefish were short some players. So Pike played the outfield because he had some experience in college. Pike made a great throw from right field to get an assist on a throwout, and the Riversharks bullpen jokingly told him, "Why don't you stay back in the bullpen?" That's what he was back then. He was not a starter for the Fish until Willie Upshaw transformed him in 2009 to the second half. The next toss is inside and low, 3 balls and 2 strikes. Chris Walker has been in the Atlantic League for a long time. York, Camden, few other teams. 3-2, Foul tipped into the glove. Strike three as Flores hangs on. Two away on the first strikeout of the night for Pike. The Bluefish defense playing straight away for Pike as Brian Bergamy digs in. He does not pull the ball, and he does not hit it to the opposite field with regularity. He hits it everywhere, sprays it with authority, which is why he's one of the league's leaders in ribbies, top 10 in the league in ribbies with 75. The two-out toss planted on the outside corner, 0-1. In winter baseball, Bergamy was robbed of an MVP award in Australia. The right-hander Pike waits and delivers. Bergamy takes one low, one ball and one strike. The idea for Pike, he would like to throw fastballs, but Bergamy is a great fastball hitter. Some of the ideas include Pike throwing more changeups to the left-handed batters. The pitch is swung on and fouled off himself. One ball and two strikes. That's always painful. Willie Upshaw and Angel Flores had a game plan today. They were talking extensively for a good half hour, about 5:30 to 6 o'clock on the left side, discussing about pitch sequence and how they would attack the hitters. The 1-2 swung on and missed on another changeup as it dives low for the second strikeout of the inning, and the Bluefish have retired the River Sharks in the first. No score after one. You're listening to Bluefish Baseball on BridgeportBluefish.com.
Miller Lite wants you to win the greatest weekend that never happened. The ultimate Vegas weekend for you and a buddy. Just collect Miller Lite taste points for your chance to win one of 100 Vegas trips being given away this summer for the big weekend. So grab Miller Lite and seize the summer at tastepoints.com. It's that easy, and it never happened. It's Miller time. No purchase necessary. Open to legal U.S. residents 21 or older. Void in California and where prohibited. Sweepstakes begins 5/1/12 and ends 8/1/12. For details, how to enter and complete official rules, go to tastepoints.com. Miller Brewing Company, Milwaukee, Wisconsin. Great beer, great responsibility.
Miller time. Don't check your wrist or follow up with your supervisor, because Miller time has nothing to do with when and everything to do with who.
What's up, Tommy?
Miller Lite is brewed for the guys you're proud to call your brothers, who'll always talk you out of getting that faux hawk and never talk.
Nice.
During your backswing. And when you've got your brothers and the light beer that tastes like a beer should, it's not just a good time, it's Miller time.
Great beer, great responsibility. Miller Brewing Company, Milwaukee, Wisconsin.
Shark tooth, screwdriver, golf tee from the golf trip that you never went golfing on, grill fork, tuning fork, fork fork, drumsticks, a motel key. Let's not talk about the motel key. Needle nose pliers, a spark plug, a domino, a house key. There's lots of things you can use to open the new Miller Lite Punch Top Can, but you'll always get the same thing. A smooth pour with less glug. However you punch it, it's Miller time. Miller Brewing Company, Milwaukee, Wisconsin. Great beer, great responsibility.
You know the bed feels warmer, sleeping here alone. Dreaming color and do the things I want. You think you got the best of me, think you've had the last laugh, bet you think that everything good is gone, think you left me broken down, think that I'll come.
We welcome you back to the Bluefish Broadcast Network. Perry Miles with you. Brian Corey is on the hill for his second inning of work, as he must deal with Willis Otañez, Luis Lopez, and James Simmons. 4, 5, and 6 in the Bluefish order as Brian Corey awaits. Otañez with an open stance. He waggles the bat. The first pitch from Corey is a fastball high. One ball and no strikes. Some ominous-looking clouds in the distance, but it's been humid. It's been hot all day. No rain so far, and none in the forecast, at least for the game, as Otañez grounds one to short, gobbled up by Igesti, takes his time and throws to first for Perez. One away on the 6-3. Otañez does not have great speed. He's in that lineup to hit for power. 291 with four homers in about a month's worth of play. One man out for Luis Lopez. Second straight season he's had double-figure home runs. Set a career high last year in home runs. More of an opposite field hitter. Plenty of doubles when he made his way to the big leagues. Backdoor slider is an outside corner pitch. No balls and one strike. Brian Corey loves to work quickly. We've seen it before. He's ready to fire again. The 0-1 is a fastball inside. One ball and one strike. Against the Bluefish, last time, five innings, one run ball. His team lost 3-2. But Corey picked up a no decision. Next toss, grounded foul on a pull to the left. One ball and two strikes. That was at the ballpark at Harbor Yard. And then the last time before that was at Bridgeport, he won the game. His results were a little bit less stellar, though. Five innings, three runs. So he's really not had too many long outings this year. Last couple, for example, is Lopez chases strike three. What appeared to be a slider diving outside. And Lopez goes down for the first strikeout of the night from Brian Corey. He has not lasted more than six innings in his last five starts. And he's lasted five innings or fewer in four of those five starts. Which means if the Bluefish get the first time around out of their system, the second time around could be the time when they attack him. Same way that it would for any starting pitcher. Corey has not had a seven-inning start since August the 7th. Somerset pitches yanked down the left field line, but it's foul. The count of no balls and one strike. James Simmons is a solid doubles hitter. Eight home runs since the All-Star break, but many of those came on the road early when the Bluefish had some extensive road trips. He's not hit one in a while. The 0-1, fastball planted inside. One ball and one strike. Simmons has had two home runs in a game twice this year. The 1-1, fastball inside. Count two balls and a strike. Last home run, though, that he hit a couple of weeks ago. Much of his turnaround attributed to Willie Upshaw and his guidance with the hitters. The 2-1 is a soft ground ball to short on three hops gathered by Igesty. The throw to first is in time. It was almost a push from Igesty, but he was able to get it across. A 1-2-3 frame as Igesty has retired three of the six Bluefish batters on ground balls. The Bluefish and the River Sharks scoreless at the end of an inning and a half. Stay tuned. You're listening to Bluefish Baseball on BridgeportBluefish.com.
Come and join the Bluefish for a playoff push in 2012. The Bluefish have great options from picnics and birthday parties to harbor club outings and suite leases. Invite your friends, family, or co-workers out to the ballpark for an exciting night of affordable family fun. Kids celebrating a birthday party at the ballpark will get an autographed baseball, a visit from BB the Bluefish, and much, much more, including a chance to compete in the best on-field promotions Connecticut has to offer. Don't miss out on the final home games of the regular season. Book your outing with the Bluefish today. Call 203-345-4800 to schedule an unforgettable day at the ballpark in Harbor Yard during the 15th anniversary season. Or go to BridgeportBluefish.com. Bridgeport Bluefish Baseball. Get hooked. We welcome you.
Hi.
At Miller Lite, we believe if you're not choosing a light beer with more taste, you need to man up, not man down. Because up is way better than down. You don't tell someone sad to cheer down. What's down, dog? A steamy pile and you just stepped in it. Your girlfriend's not wearing a push-down bra. It's called gravity, Isaac Nitwit. Can I be down front with you? All this down talk is bringing me down. So don't man down, man up, and choose a light beer with more taste. Triple hops brewed Miller Lite. Taste greatness. Miller Brewing Company, Milwaukee, Wisconsin. Great beer, great responsibility.
Number two, Pedro.
We welcome you back to the Bluefish broadcast. Perry Miles with you. Pedro Feliz is in the batter's box, the former big leaguer. He's followed by Raul Patron and Eduardo Perez. 4, 5, and 6 due up for the River Sharks tonight. Light fixtures are on. It's humid at the ballpark as Pike
weighs in for the sign, gets the signal and delivers. Pitch is grounded to short, shooting over a couple of steps to his right and firing across is Eddie Rogers. One out in the second. 6-3 on the putout for Pedro Feliz as Raul Padron digs in. Willie Upshaw wanted to avoid throwing baseballs middle in to Padron. You never want to go middle in and especially low in the zone, because that's where he feels that Padron can generate the most power. And the left-handed sweet spot is low and in, about knee high, because all you need to do is flick the wrist at the ball and you generate plenty of power that way. Ideally, get it above the belt away. The one out toss, fastball established inside as Padron appeared to be creeping into the box. One ball and no strikes. He seems to start out further from the plate and then ball one strike. Raul Padron is one of the better River Sharks hitters, but he's only been with the team for a couple of months. 37 ribbies, a .272 average for the native of Venezuela a week, 3-4 games a week because of his offensive funk. Those two were not a part of the River Sharks for the first couple of months of the season because they had visa issues. The 1-2, fastball high, two balls and two strikes. Those two, Eddie Camacho and Carlos Vasquez, one of those four, Vasquez, was released. Just did not have the command, the same kind of command that he did a year ago when Vasquez was one of the league's leaders in victories. Two balls and two strikes with one man out. Pike delivers and the pitch flattens low. Two balls and two strikes becomes 3-2. One man out in the bottom of the second inning. Luis Lopez hovering towards the chalk at first. Brad Boyer well off the third base bag. He's almost close to short. Seems to be a large field, and the baseball carries very well off the grass on the ground. 3-2 is chopped slowly towards third. Boyer gathers, takes his time, and rips to first in time to retire Padron. Two away on the 5-3 as Eduardo Perez digs in. First base, the pitching is so much better in this league than it was a year ago. In talking with a couple of broadcasters, a couple of executives from around the league, they admit that the pitching seems to be more ahead of the hitting this year than it was last year. And this was known for quite a while as a hitter-friendly league, with Southern Maryland contributing to that and Bridgeport, Long Island, quite a few teams. Not the same kind of productivity this year as the two-out toss is angled high, one ball and no strikes. And perhaps with the influence of Roger Clemens and if many other past big leaguers making their way to the Atlantic League right away, as the 1-0 is a fastball in the outside corner, one ball and one strike. That influence may result in some of the players that had long time big league experience to get back into Atlantic League play, continue to do what they love to do. The 1-1, slap foul, inside out poke, a ball and two strikes. And one of the biggest stories in sports is the second start for Roger Clemens, which is taking place tonight at Constellation Field against the Ducks. He is pitching to his son, Kobe Clemens. So Cody Clemens going from the Blue Jays organization specifically for that as the next toss is outside. Two balls and two strikes. He received permission from Toronto's AA affiliate, the New Hampshire Fisher Cats, to come down to Texas to provide catching services for them. It's an ESPN game tonight. Two balls and two strikes. Pike delivers. Pitch swung on and missed. High cheese. Got him. And that retires the side. Eduardo Perez becomes the third strikeout victim for Pike. The Bluefish and the River Sharks are scoreless through two. You're listening to Bluefish Baseball on BridgeportBluefish.com.
We ask that all cancer survivors.
Hey kids, it's not too late to join BB and all of his friends by becoming a member of the Bluefish Snappers Club. The Snappers Club is the newest club for all of the biggest or littlest Bluefish fans. As a member of the Snappers Club, you'll not only get free entrance on Snappers Club Day, but you'll also get a membership card to show all of your friends. plus a special t-shirt that will tell everyone you're a member of the club. After each Sunday home game, Baseball Bunch members will also be invited onto the field to run the bases, just like the Bluefish do. You'll even receive a newsletter that will fill you in on all of your favorite Bluefish players, along with all the news that BB Snappers Club has to offer. To join the coolest club around, call 203-345-4800 or go to bridgeportbluefish.com/kids/snappers to become a member of BB's Snappers Club.
Hey Bluefish fans, have you heard about the clubhouse? Conveniently located in Fairfield, it has an unparalleled team of baseball and softball instructors offering private instruction, camps, team training rentals, and best of all, the chance to learn from an all-pro team including Mike Porzio, former MLB pitcher, and the Bluefish's very own Willie Upshaw. Open 7 days a week. Stop in and meet our team or call us 203-292-8700 and visit us at the web, theclubhouseCT.com, and get the major league experience.
This is Paul Segura, and you're listening to Bridgeport Bluefish Baseball.
The Bluefish Broadcast Network, Perry Miles with you. Brian Corey's on the hill. This is one of the best ballparks in the league. Aesthetically pleasing to all. Brad Boyer, before, had something to say regarding this ballpark, and we'll get to that piece of audio right after this happened and comes to a close. But he talked about the Ben Franklin Bridge, the causeway that separates, that you can tell by the top of your screen, the top of your viewing screen, with many cars traveling across the top. And it's almost blending in with the blue sky. Camden on the right side and the far right side, Philadelphia well to the left, out of your visual, as the first pitch is sliding to the outside corner, 0-1. To Boyer, a third baseman this year, has been had an up and down season. The pitches swung on and missed. Count of no balls and two strikes. Much better with the Bluefish, though. He's at 253, two homers, and 11 ribbies with the fish. Coming off of an 0-for-4 as the pitch is looped in the air to right field. It dunks in for a base hit. Brad Boyer gets on first and hustles around the base as the throw comes in to second from Brian Burgundy. Brad Boyer picks up the first hit of the game for either side as Luis Figueroa steps up. Figueroa came over to the Bluefish from the Sugar Land Skeeters and has provided a boost for this Bluefish squad throughout the time. He's done a tremendous job on the defensive side. And offensively, he is one of the best players, especially making contact. Gets on base often and drives in the key runs. The first pitch is sent foul to the left. No balls and one strike. Each of the last games during the week, he's batted second, which means he's a bunter, he's a hitter, he can hit and run. He does not strike out often. He does the little things in order for the Bluefish to come up with a victory. Boyer scampers off of first. The next toss is lifted down the left field line, giving chase to Feliz, but he runs out of real estate. No balls and two strikes. Not much wind tonight. It is so humid, so hot out here. You almost have to wear an undershirt to prevent yourself from sweating. It's almost like a steam room. No balls and two strikes and nobody out. Corey delivers pitch, planted inside. One ball and two strikes on a fastball. The Bluefish and the River Sharks scoreless. A hit for Bridgeport. Switch hitting. Figueroa batting from the left side against the righty. Corey lifts his leg and deals. Pitch, line drive, foul. Sent screaming past Perez down the right field line towards the bullpen. Zach Hammes appeared to get the baseball in the right field corner. He's one of the members of the bullpen and an all-star for the Atlantic League's Liberty Division earlier this year. 7:36 on the East Coast. Runner goes. The pitch is a fastball inside the throw to second. Not in time. The throw is a little bit higher than normal. A good jump by Boyer. Angel Flores was explaining earlier this year, you want to get the throw 3 to 6 inches off the ground. That throw was anywhere from belt high to stomach high, which is not terrible, but it causes that extra tenth of a second to apply the tag. And that's how much Boyer was safe by the 2-2. Slap foul to the left, 2 balls and 2 strikes. It is always important for the catcher to make that accurate throw right at the bag to be caught, and so that way the runner slides right into the tag. Not much effort required on either the second baseman or the shortstop to cover that base. 2 balls and 2 strikes. Corey delivers. Pitch is roped into left center field, but it hangs high enough, and it is caught by Reed Gorecki. Little lip, but Gorecki understands the kind of hitter Figueroa is. And even after that stolen base by Brad Boyer, and Angel Flores immediately becomes the pizza man. There's a K-man everywhere in the Atlantic League. And whoever strikes out that particular K-man for the night, there's usually a special prize attached. In this case, one slice of pizza for the fans. If there are 3 strikeouts, I believe it's a whole pie at this ballpark. The one out toss is inside, 1 ball and no strikes. 1 strikeout, 1 slice, 2 strikeouts, 2 slices, 3 strikeouts, well, might as well go the whole 9 yards, right? 1 ball and no strikes, 1 man out. Second baseman Delwin Young angling towards second, backpedals towards first. The pitch is swung on and foul, tipped at the plate, 1 ball and 1 strike. The River Sharks and the Bluefish. Game one of this 4-game series, the River Sharks have been struggling. They just lost 3 out of 4 to Southern Maryland, in which the Blue Crabs had won several extra inning games. They did not do it last night, though. Southern Maryland has been the best team in extras. The 1-1 is lifted in the air to deep left field, backpedaling and settling underneath to make the catch. Chris Walker for out number 2. It was a long drive by Flores, but did not quite get on the sweet spot in the bat. Just got a little bit above the sweet spot, induced more of a fly ball rather than a long line drive. Kennard Jones steps up. Runner in scoring position. Jones 0 for 1 with a line drive to short. He stands in from the left side, slightly twitching his elbow as he waggles that bat. The 2-out toss, chopped on the ground to the right side. Charging forward, Delwin Young. He fields and throws to first, is having to adjust his feet to make the play. Eduardo Perez for the final out of the frame. Not an accurate throw, but well-placed feet from Eduardo Perez. That retires the side. 1 base hit, 1 runner left in scoring position. End of 2.5, the Bluefish and the River Sharks. Scoreless. You're listening to Bluefish Baseball. I'm BridgeportBluefish.com. At this time, we would like to present to you the Brad Boyer audio that we were talking about before. He talked about the ballpark and the aesthetic nature of it. Hear what he had to say about the view.
I'd have to say, just the aesthetic view. You got to love the bridge and the background. Just gives you a feeling of being in that big city, and it's always nice to have a view like that.
You ever run across the bridge before?
Never have. I'm not on that pitching routine. I got to keep these legs fresh to get around the bases.
Why do we love baseball? Is it the uniforms, the pace of the game, the mascots? Could be. Or could it be that what we really love is that baseball reminds us how we can all come out ahead when we work together, just like a good team? At Prudential Annuities, we understand that when everyone works together, good things can happen. That's why each year, we uphold a commitment to helping charitable causes in our community by pitching in financial resources and by enabling Prudential Annuities employees to help others through volunteer work. From conducting mentoring programs and helping homeless shelters to supporting health awareness and food banks, Prudential Annuities is more than a big company in Fairfield County. We're a big part of the community, too. Prudential Annuities, going to bat for the community.
The Prudential Insurance Company of America, Newark, New Jersey, and its affiliates. Prudential Annuities is a business of Prudential Financial, Inc.
Back to the Bluefish Broadcast Network. Perry Miles with you. Bottom of the third inning. Matt Pike has thrown two scoreless frames. Brian Corey has thrown three straight zeros up on the board. The Bluefish and the River Sharks have yet to score as Alvin Colina digs in, followed by Jake Agosti and Delwin Young, 7, 8, and 9 in the order for the home team. The right-hander Pike has been able to mix up his fastballs, his changeups, and his sliders so far. And he's not featured the breaking ball at this point. Right-hander weighs in for the signal and receives. Setup is toward the outside. The next pitch is a fastball inside underneath the armpit. One ball and no strikes. An emerging crowd at the ballpark believes there's a fireworks extravaganza following the conclusion of this ball game, and most of those fireworks take place in left field as the pitch is driven to left center field. Way back, James Simmons, he's towards the track, he's nearing the wall and makes the play as he goes up against the wall where the Bud Light sign was. One away on the F7 as Jake Agosti moves in. He was an American Association All-Star last year, and this year he has shown why he belongs in this league. Defensively, very good range and a solid arm. Offensively, driving in some runs, 42 on the year, batting towards the bottom of the order. Early in the season, when the Bluefish played the River Sharks often, played them in the first four games when Brett Doughty got hurt, a few other players got hurt, Jake Agosti was driving in runs, scoring runs, and helping the team win. Him and Shea Harris. The one out tosses outside and low, one ball and no strikes. But as the season progresses, Agosti moved down in the order. Shea Harris was released from the team and picked up momentarily because of the injury to Alvin Colina last time that the Bluefish were here. The 1-0 slider on the outside corner, one ball and one strike. Camden has gone through a number of injuries. Jeff Scott, the manager of the team in his first year managing Camden, he was a pitching coach and was the manager of the Road Warriors for a period of time. The 1-1, fastball low, two balls and one strike. Became the director of baseball operations for the River Sharks. So he has complete control over, or most of the control, as to who he decides he wants to bring in on the field. It's all about putting up the wins, the 2-1, fastball tucked inside, three balls and a strike. Von Hayes was the manager each of the last couple of seasons, but the River Sharks were unable to return to the form that they once experienced with what they showed on the field. Three balls and one strike to Agosti. Delwin Young is waiting on deck. Righty versus righty. The 3-1 from Pike. Fastball to the outside corner. Three balls and two strikes. Very difficult to hit a pitch on the outside quadrant when you're looking for one zone. Willie Upshaw always talks about a batter identifying in that quadrant, in the zone. If the pitcher's able to expand upon that, they'll be effective. The 3-2 line drive, knocked down partially by Pike. It did not matter. It's a base hit to right center field. It went slightly off the glove of Pike. Usually, Pike would get out of the way, but that time went right towards his glove. He tried to knock it down, slow it down. All he could do was graze his glove as it raced to right center field. It is a base hit for Agosti to set up Delwin Young. The second baseman has struggled in the Atlantic League. The guy played 5 years of Major League Baseball with the Dodgers and the Pirates. Yet he's finding no luck in this league, and much of it has to do with the command of the pitches. These pitchers are that competent this year. The one-out toss, a fastball located outside, one ball and no strikes. Angel Flores quickly goes out to the mound. Perhaps it was a bit of miscommunication, Pike had been falling behind in the count, last batter. And so Flores just wants to make sure that Pike still has the confidence that Flores and Pike can trust each other with implicit communication. Because sometimes it's not about putting signals down. Many teams, unintentionally or intentionally, have stolen signs, which leads to more productive offensive outputs. The 1-0. Chopped on the ground at first, grabbed by Lopez, steps on the bag, throws the second, double play, if the tag was applied, which it was, as the third base umpire got over there to make the call. Great play made by Lopez Bill Reeder with the one who made it. Three scoreless innings so far for Pike, one hit allowed, but that runner eliminated on the double play. At the end of three, no score from Camden. You're listening to Bluefish Baseball on BridgeportBluefish.com.
Tony Rollins talks about the Baseball Hall of Fame.
This being in the same place that all these great ball players, you know, reside at now, their career, you go find their stats, their jerseys, their helmets, their cleats, and have something of mine, that is something that anybody that goes to the Hall of Fame can see.
Preserving history, honoring excellence, connecting generations. At the National Baseball Hall of Fame and Museum in Cooperstown, New York. Connect with Cooperstown at baseballhall.org.
Hey kids, it's not too late to join BB and all of his friends by becoming a member of the Bluefish Snappers Club. The Snappers Club is the newest club for all of the biggest or littlest Bluefish fans. As a member of the Snappers Club, you'll not only get free entrance on Snappers Club Day, but you'll also get a membership card to show all of your friends, plus a special t-shirt that will tell everyone you're a member of the club. After each Sunday home game, Baseball Bunch members will also be invited onto the field to run the bases, just like the Bluefish do. You'll even receive a newsletter that will fill you in on all of your favorite Bluefish players, along with all the news that BB Snappers Club has to offer. To join the coolest club around, call 203-345-4800 or go to BridgeportBluefish.com/kids/snappers to become a member of BB's Snappers Club.
You know the bed feels warmer, sleeping here alone.
We welcome you back to the Bluefish broadcast. Perry Miles with you. It's the top of the fourth inning. Eddie Rogers leads off. He's followed by Prentice Redmond and Willis Otañez. 2, 3, and 4 in the order for the road team. As Brian Corey makes his way to the hill. This is one of the longer stints that he's had in each of his last five starts. If he's able to complete the inning, he will have gone four, and maximum number that he's gone on each of the five starts is six. The next toss is outside, one ball and no strikes. Bridgeport's offense has been struggling for the most part over the last month. They've had to play the likes of Somerset, Southern Maryland, and Lancaster in the process. The pitch is pulled foul to the left, one ball and one strike. But all these teams are getting a bit tired out there, and you wonder if the Bluefish pitching will be able to take advantage of those hitters, and the Bluefish bats will be able to produce enough to be able to make up the ground that they need to in order to make a postseason run, a valid postseason run. The 1-1 fastball scoots outside, two balls and a strike. Camden just dealt with a number of close games against Southern Maryland, some of them self-inflicted pains. Next pitch is grounded, base hit right field. Nice piece of hitting for Rogers. He did not try to do too much with the ball as he sent a sharp grounder to the right side beyond the reach of Delwin Young. Brian Burgamy threw it into Young on the relay to second base. Leadoff single sets up Prentice Redmond. Redmond is 0-4-1 on the day. He grounded out too short in the first inning. Righty versus righty. As Corey digs in, so does Redmond. 34 doubles. In addition to the 16 home runs, the throw to first is not in time. At one point, Redmond was on fire, back-to-back games with shots. But he has not had a home run in a few games. really since the start of the Lancaster series. Next toss, line drive, base hit, left center field. Stopping at second base, Eddie Rogers, as the ball comes in from Walker to Eichesty. The first Bluefish rally going, runners at first and second for Willis Otañez. Otañez is a solid bat. He has the authority to hit the ball with power to right center field without opening up too much with his front shoulder and still be able to smack the ball to left field. The way that he's able to smack the ball is one of the cleanest and smoothest approaches that there is by any batter in the Atlantic League. It is because of his approach. Not many flaws in the swing. Sometimes he will get longer if there are breaking balls to the extremities of the strike zone as the pitch is lifted in the air to deep left field. Going back is Walker. He's towards the track and makes the play for the first out. Eddie Rogers retreats to second base as he was not planning on moving over to third. A long out for Otañez on the F7. Luis Lopez digs in. Otañez spent all of 2011 with the River Sharks, whenever he was in the Atlantic League. Lopez stands in. Strikeout victim in the second inning. Ron Karkovice is the one that will make the changes and the calls to the bullpen, even though Jeff Scott is the one that is essentially saying which pitcher should warm up. The one out toss, the fastball down the middle, 0-1. Jeff Scott will make an indication to Ron Karkovice. Karkovice will relay the communication down the right field line. There are only a handful of times that Jeff Scott will make his way out from the dugout towards the mound. Next toss swerves inside. One ball and one strike. Scott was a member of the Texas Rangers starting rotation 60s and 70s. Plenty of experience as a baseball player, developing talent, and involved in operational work. The 1-1 tucked inside. Two balls and one strike. Lopez, more than 2,100 hits. He has done a phenomenal job in his stint, in his several stints with the Bluefish. Right-hander waits. The next pitch swung on and missed. Lopez expected fastball. Anticipation was off the mark. Got something off speed. Two balls and two strikes, one man out. Top of the fourth inning, no score from Campbell's. Lopez is in the box. James Simmons will get a shot at the plate. If Lopez is able to get on, the pitch is roped to left field, but it's well foul. Home run distance, but not home run location. Two balls and two strikes. For more information on Bluefish baseball, you go to the website, bridgeportbluefish.com. You can also send me an email, perrym86@gmail.com, perrym86@gmail.com. You can also follow me on Twitter, just me, P. Miles. Just me, P. Miles. Two balls, two strikes, one man out. Right-hander steps off the rubber before he re-establishes his presence on the slab. Will the runners be off on two balls, two strikes? Eddie Rogers, Prentice Redmond have decent speed. The 2-2 is poked foul. Lopez lunged at it to stay alive. This is the final series for the Bluefish against the River Sharks during the regular season, and most likely the final time that these two teams will match up, period, because at best, one of these teams is probably going to miss the playoffs. The Bluefish are the ones more likely to make it at this juncture. The 2-2 sent foul to the right. Count remains, two balls and two strikes. Let's get you a quick scoreboard update courtesy of PointStreak.com and AtlanticLeague.com.
The Southern Maryland Blue Crabs lead the York Revolution 1-0. The Skeeters and Ducks about to get underway. Less than 10 minutes, the runners go. The pitch is lined off the glove of Pedro Feliz. Rounding third and coming to the plate is Eddie Rogers. Redmond scampers into third. That probably should have been caught. And we will see if the error is ruled. That ball is a line drive towards Feliz. And it looked like Feliz was going to grab it. And all of a sudden, it went off the thumb of his glove and into left field. Still no determination on the play. Lopez smacked that baseball. It's a 1-0 lead for the Bluefish as Eddie Rogers scores. It is an E5, no RBI. Should have been a line drive out. Runners at first and second. There's a home run right now. Then the Bluefish runs would be earned except for Lopez's. As he got on base, the one out pitch is swung on and served into deep left center field. On the move, Walker. He's towards the track. He's at the wall. That ball is gone. 3-run shot. James Simmons. He surged it to left center field. He provides the Bluefish with a jolt of energy. Simmons rounds the bases to give the Bluefish a 4-0 lead. That was a big shot by a powerful hitter in Simmons. Deposits the ball to left center field. Got plenty of carry on the ball. That went well over the second wall where the Wawa sign is located. And Brian Corey has given up 3 earned runs in this frame. Sure enough, the home run for Simmons, 12 on the year. And his RBI total jumps to 40. The one-out delivery to Boyer is lifted down the right field line, but it twists foul towards the fit and fun zone down the right side. An E5 line drive that could have wound up being a double play because the runners had moved off their bases. Significant portion costs Camden 4 runs. Next toss is inside. 1-1. For those of you who just tuned in, line drive to record was supposed to record the second out. It was mishandled by Feliz. The next fastball turned inside. 2-1. Led to the first run of the ball game. Scoring is Eddie Rogers' cross. Redmond moved on to third. After that play, a 3-run shot to left center field by James Simmons as Boyer takes a big cut and fouls it off. 2-2. You could hear the oohs and the ahs in the background. They were in anticipation, but Bluefish fans, they have nothing to worry about right now. The 2-2. A chopper slowly struck to the mound. Fielding to the right, Corey throws to first in time. Two-way. A 1-3 putout for Boyer as Luis Figueroa digs in. The crooked number puts the Bluefish on top, and Matt Pike tonight looks sharp. We will see if he's able to keep this up. We told you earlier in the broadcast about how Corey had not lasted more than 6 innings, and in the last 4 starts, 5 innings or less. The 2-out tosses slice foul to the left, 0-1. Well, you just saw that the River Sharks defense cost him 1 run minimum. And James Simmons deposited a 3-run shot. Next toss, line drive caught towards first. A soft line drive off the trademark to end the threat. But the Bluefish score 4 runs on 3 base hits. The big drive, a 3-run shot from James Simmons. And the Bluefish have a 4-0 advantage at the end of 3.5. Stay tuned. You're listening to Bluefish Baseball on BridgeportBluefish.com.
Screwdriver, skeleton key, golf tee from the golf trip that you never went golfing on, grill fork, tuning fork, fork fork, the lucky fishing lure you snagged Alan with, sorry Alan, drumsticks, chopsticks from the place you met that Dallas-based flight attendant, a motel key, let's not talk about the motel key, a spark plug, domino, a house key.
How do these things make Miller Lite from a can even better? Find out May 2012. Miller Brewing Company, Milwaukee, Wisconsin. Great beer, great responsibility.
Come and join the Bluefish for a playoff push in 2012. The Bluefish have great options from picnics and birthday parties to harbor club outings and speakeasies. Invite your friends, family, or coworkers out to the ballpark for an exciting night of affordable family fun. Kids celebrating a birthday party at the ballpark will get an autographed baseball, a visit from BB the Bluefish, and much, much more, including a chance to compete in the best on-field promotions Connecticut has to offer. Don't miss out on the final home game of the regular season. Book your outing with the Bluefish today. Call 203-345-4800 to schedule an unforgettable day at the ballpark in Harbor Yard during the 15th anniversary season. Or go to BridgeportBluefish.com. Bridgeport Bluefish Baseball. Get hooked. Network continues as Matt Pike is on the hill for another inning. 4-0 to score. The Bluefish on top. Run scoring error and a 3-run shot by James Simmons, highlighting that momentum swing can usually lead to a victory by the team that push across all those runs. Bridgeport is more business to take care of. Bluefish Matt Pike gave up a hit in the last inning, but also induced a double play ball to eliminate that base runner. Back to the top of the order with Reed Gorecki, Chris Walker, and Brian Bergamy. Gorecki is 0-for-1 today with a fly ball to center in his first at-bat. It's almost as if the Riversharks, they wanted Gorecki badly. But it was not as if Gorecki was going to play over the players that were on the Ducks. The likes of Esquivel, as the first pitch is a fastball to the inside corner, 0-1. Or maybe a Joe Ashbrodine, or perhaps Craig Binnick, the 0-1. Bunt shown, it goes above the glove of Machete. Went off of it. One ball and one strike. We are in the bottom of the fourth inning from Campbell's Field. Long Island and Sugar Land about to get underway. I am sure there is a big spotlight tonight. Clemens on the hill for the Skeeters. The next toss chopped on the ground slowly to the left side. Rogers, Fields, grips and throws one away. It is a 6-3 on the putout. Top of the first inning from Constellation Field.
The left fielder, number one,
as the Skeeters and the Ducks. Randy Kiesler for Long Island is back against Clemens. Two former big leaguers. One for the Yankees. Actually, both of them played for the Yankees at one point. Chris Walker digs in. Walker, a strikeout victim in the first inning. Righty versus lefty as Pike moves the leg back. The first pitch, rear on the outside corner, 0-1. Pike has been able to induce the ground ball. Everything seems to be A-OK for the right-hander. The one-strike toss. Fastball tucked inside. One ball, one strike. Walker has 11 home runs, but he is not a power hitter. He may be going for more home runs the later stages of his career because that's what he feels he can do, is the 1-1 is slack down the left field line, giving chase towards the corner but unable to get there, is Kennard Jones. One ball and two strikes. Jones tried to sprint. Sprinted towards the chalk but fell well out of play. For those of you who've never been to this ballpark before, we talked about the dimensions, 325, 365, and 405. Down the left field line, you have a picnic area. You have the fit and fun zone with a rock climbing facility on the right side.
Camden bullpen down the right side as well. The 1-2 is chopped in front of the mound, gathered by Pike. He throws the first two away. 1-3 for Walker as Brian Bergamy swoops in. Down the left field area, you have the picnic facility. The upper deck features an unusual luxury suite area. A large area down the right side with smaller suite sections to its left, running from down the right field line to above us down the left field corridor. Two men out for Bergamy. Pike stares in, glove rotates, so does his legs as the first pitch is inside, 1-1 and no strikes. Bergamy has had a great season against the Bluefish, well, hitting well above the 300 mark. It's one of the teams that he's been very successful against. The 1-0 is a fastball, steaming high, 2-1 and no strikes. James Simmons playing deep in center. He's almost towards the warning track, understanding how the jet stream is in this venue. The 2-0 from Pike to Bergamy, a fastball down Broad Street, 2-1. 4-4-0 to 0-1-1. Bluefish scored four runs in the top of this frame. The 2-1, fastball located outside, 3-1. Pike is yet to walk a batter, but Bergamy leads the league in walks. Not uncommon for him to take his base. 3-1. Low ball 4. Did not want much to do with Brian Bergamy, knowing how much damage he could do with the bat. Maybe start a rally. 2-out walk to string Pedro Feliz forward.
Third baseman, number 2,
Pedro Feliz, a former World Series champion. Philadelphia Phillies. Part of three World Series representative teams. Two with Philadelphia, one with San Francisco. The 2-out delivery from Pike. Slider outside, 1-1 and no strikes. You can tell. Light fixtures are on, it's a hazy night. Little bit of fog developing close to the river. The 1-0, a high drive towards left center field. James Simmons sprints over, calls for the ball, and makes the play in the alley for the final out of the frame. The Bluefish give up a 2-out walk, but that runner does not score. At the end of 4, the Bluefish own a 4-0 lead. Stay tuned. You're listening to Bluefish Baseball on BridgeportBluefish.com. We'll be right back. The Bluefish have great gifts and giveaways coming up at the ballpark at Harbor Yard, beginning with a series against the Southern Maryland Blue Crabs on September 11th. That Tuesday is Kids Eat Free, presented by Big Y World Class Market. Kids 12 and under are entitled to a hot dog, potato chips, and a fountain beverage. Wednesday is Bark in the Park Night, presented by Canine Company, followed by Thirsty Thursday, presented by Budweiser. Friday the 14th kicks off Fan Appreciation Weekend with a fireworks extravaganza presented by Sabret. 7:05 first pitch for each game during the week. Saturday the 15th features 2 7-inning games as part of a doubleheader beginning at 1 p.m. from Bridgeport. Race Pass giveaway is sponsored by Grand Prix of New York. Sunday is all about family fun as there is a kids autograph session before the game and kids run the bases afterwards. The 2:05 first pitch on Sunday with gates opening 1 hour before each first pitch. Tickets are available for the series by going to BridgeportBluefish.com or by calling 203-345-4800. Bridgeport Bluefish Baseball. Get hooked.
Hey, Bluefish fans. Have you heard about the clubhouse? Conveniently located in Fairfield, it has an unparalleled team of baseball and softball instructors offering private instruction, camps, team training, rentals, and best of all, the chance to learn from an all-pro team, including Mike Porzio, former MLB pitcher, and the Bluefish's very own Willie Upshaw. Open 7 days a week. Stop in and meet our team or call us 203-292-8700 and visit us at the web, theclubhouseCT.com, and get the Major League experience.
Thank you.
Bluefish and the River Sharks shift to the top of the fifth inning with the Bluefish leading 4-0. James Simmons with a 3-run home run tonight for the Bluefish, accounting for 3/4 of their offense. The other one on an unearned run on a line drive that was bobbled by the third baseman Pedro Feliz as a runner came to the plate. The first pitch planted low, 1-0. That base runner was Eddie Rogers. 1-0 to Flores. 9-1-2 due up for the Fish as the next toss is served outside. 2-0. Flores is 0-1. Kennard Jones and Eddie Rogers. Those three are due up. The Camden defense hovering towards third. The 2-0 fastball to the outside quadrant. 2-1. Nobody out. The right-hander delivers. Pitch is slap foul to the right. Off the facade and ricochets into the set of seats. Fortunately, it did not strike anyone on the ricochet off the facade or the seats following that. And we have to emphasize, continue to emphasize, safety is of the utmost concern. Make sure that you protect yourself. The 2-2 pitch is inside, 3-2. On a floating changeup. Watch out for flying baseballs, flying bats, and broken bats. Watch the game at all times. The 3-2. Chopper to the left side. The shortstop, I can see, gathers in the hole, bobbles for a moment, throws on the move. It hops into the dirt for a nice hop for the first baseman, Eduardo Perez. One away. Flores could not beat it out. Igasti threw it, knowing that Flores does not have great speed down the first base side. Catchers tend to be the least fleet of foot among all positional players. Look at the Molina brothers. They're in the big leagues. They call great games. They hit very well. But, man, tortoises might be able to defeat them in a race. The one-out delivery from the right-hander, fastball. Served high, 1-0. Kennard Jones is 0-2. Open stance, waggles the bat, setup is outside, pitches, foul tipped into the glove, 1-1. Most of the pitchers have been trying to establish the outside quadrant and command further outside to induce swings and misses from Jones. His eyes may be telling him one thing, but the bat is telling him differently as the pitch is served foul. 1-2. And once they establish the command outside, they'll throw jam shots on fastballs inside. So Jones is not on top of that. He's constantly thinking of where the ball is. If you get the batter to think, even for a slight moment, it'll work. The 1-2, fastball further inside, 2-2. Hesitation is the hitter's worst nightmare. All the hitter needs to do is react. The 2-2, fastball outside, 3-2. Jones knew where that ball was going to land because he, just like many of the other ball players, able to see the ball right from the hand. 20-20 vision or better from most of the competitors. 3-2, served on a high pop foul out of play. Pedro Feliz drifted towards the chalk, but stopped because he knew it was going 5 to 10 rows back. 3-2. 4-4-0 to 0-1-1. Top of the fifth inning from just outside of Philadelphia. We thank everybody for tuning in. If you have any questions, comments, or concerns about the Bluefish broadcast, you can send me an email. 3-2 is low, ball four. Got away from Padron, but Jones is focused on going to first. He reaches base for the first time tonight as Eddie Rogers digs in. A single, a run scored, a fly ball to center for Rogers. There's nobody warming up in the bullpen for the River Sharks, but you wonder why they're all standing up down the right field line. It's a hot and humid day. There is a bench down there. Not as if the Bluefish are standing up. Most of them are in the
dugout if they are standing up, and one or two pitchers are hanging out down the left field line. The one out toss is swung on and missed, 0-1 on a changeup. Center fielder Gorecki straight away. Same with the corner outfielders, Bergamy in right, Walker in left. Not shifting. The 0-1 on its way to Rogers. If there is any hole, it's towards the right side of the infield. The 0-1 is poked foul to the left. No balls and two strikes, which is where Rogers picked up his first hit, a poke to the right side. Not much room up the middle, which is a place that Rogers sometimes is called home. He just serves the ball to center. Much of the time, he does pull the ball. More so over the second half, which has led to better results. Timeout was called. With catcher Padron scampering in front of the home plate to talk with his pitcher, Brian Corey, before the two get their set of signals straightened out. No balls and two strikes. One man out. Corey stares in, gets the signal, lifts his leg, the 0-2, slap foul to the netting, ricocheted off the netting towards the warning track. No balls and two strikes. In Sugarland, so far Roger Clemens has thrown a scoreless frame, and it seems as if the Skeeters have a rally going. The bases appear to be loaded with nobody out. Next toss, fastball upstairs, one ball and two strikes. There is that much of a difference when Roger Clemens is on the mound compared with everyone else on the mound. It's surreal. The Skeeters seem to perform well. He doesn't give up hits or walks. And then the Skeeters wind up providing him with plenty of offensive support. The 1-2 is chopped on the ground, base hit to right field. Eddie Rogers goes the same way, two straight at bats, and he comes up with two successive positive results. Runners at first and second for Prentice Redman.
Take out the paper, then the track. Right fielder number 27.
Redman is one for two tonight. It is a sold out crowd from Skeeter Country. Meanwhile, the Bluefish don't care about that. They care about the other score in the Atlantic League, and that's Southern Maryland and New York. The Blue Crabs lead the Revolution 2-0. If the Revolution were to go into a tailspin somehow, and the Bluefish somehow were to sweep the River Sharks, they might have an opportunity, as the first pitch dives to the inside corner, 0-1. They might have a chance to catch York in the wild card standings, but it would take drastic measures like that in order for the Bluefish to catch them. Worst case scenario, Southern Maryland wins 3 out of 4 against the Revolution. The 0-1, grounded foul to the left, no balls and two strikes. Brian Corey's pitch count over the last couple of innings, rising. It's going up substantially. Count of no balls and two strikes. Pitch hit him. Redman got plunked with the pitch inside. And that gives you all you need to know about the way that Corey's control has gone south over the last couple of innings. It was two singles, an error, and a home run.
40, Willis Atomia.
Walk, single, and hit by pitch to load the bases for the Bluefish. For Willis Otañez, and no pitcher wants to deal with Otañez with runners in scoring position. They understand how well he's able to hit over a period of time. 4 home runs with the Bluefish, a total of 23 between the Mexican League regular season and the postseason. The first pitch twists outside, 1 ball and no strikes. And he's facing similar pitching, maybe even better pitching in this league than
in the Mexican League. Plenty of breaking balls featured in AAA Independent Mexico. The 1-0 flattens low, two balls and no strikes. There appears to be activity brewing down the right field line for the River Sharks, as one member from the bullpen frays away from the flock. It is a right-handed pitcher. From this angle, we cannot tell what number it is from this. The 2-0. Otañez lays off an outside slider, 3-0. It appears to be Santo Hernandez, who pitched two innings of scoreless relief against the Blue Crabs 2 days ago, before the River Sharks lost that game. The 3-0, swung on and driven to deep left center field. No chance for the center fielder. Grand slam home run. Reed Gorecki just stared at it. Gorecki knew it was well out of the park, and Otañez drills it to left center field. The Bluefish extend the lead. It is 8-0. A grand slam for Otañez. Left it middle up, and Otañez wrecked it. That was a boom.
First baseman, number 19.
Gorecki, all he could do was stare, and Otañez with his fifth home run. RBI number 11, 12, 13, and 14 with the Fish. Here comes Luis Lopez. 0 for 2 tonight, the one out, tosses a fastball over the middle, 0-1. This is by far the most run support that Matt Pike has had all season as a starter. The 0-1, breaking ball, swung on and missed, no balls and two strikes. And you could see why Brian Corey's getting touched up. The 0-2, slap foul to the right, no balls and two strikes. The Bluefish in control right now. 8-0 to score on BridgeportBluefish.com. Perry Miles with you. Back-to-back four-run efforts by the road team. The 0-2, grounded foul to the left. Count remains at no balls and two strikes. We said that Southern Maryland was leading York 2-0. That's in the bottom of the fourth now. The Skeeters and the Ducks, bottom of the first, no score. Next pitch is inside. One ball and two strikes on Heat. Somerset and Lancaster tied at 2. And it appears that Kiesler has recorded two outs without giving up a run. Will the Skeeters strand more base runners? The 1-2, grounded towards third, gobbled up by Feliz, takes his time and rips the throw to first in time. Two away on the 5-3. The inning started with a 6-3. But walks have been the mental bane of any pitcher's existence. For eons, it seems, since Abner Doubleday came up with the sport baseball back near the time of the Civil War. And there is no difference between a walk and a single in terms of bases, except that you expend more energy by throwing four baseballs instead of 0, 1, 2, 3. And maybe the pitcher loses confidence that the fastball turned inside, one ball and no strikes. Pitchers never like to throw walks because maybe the pitcher feels a bit gun shy after missing the strike. So the 1-0 is inside, two balls and no strikes. Maybe they can't get the outside quadrant, so they have to go more to the middle of the plate. Statistics show hitters hit better when the ball's over the middle. The 2-0 is grounded foul, two balls and one strike. Logical deduction. Bluefish smacked the baseball. They've done that against Corey today. Two big home runs. Not the solo variety. A grand slam, Otañez this inning, as the next pitch floats high.
three balls and a strike, and a three-run shot in the previous inning by James Simmons. And with that grand slam, Willis Otañez extends his on-base streak to 14 in a row as the pitch hits Simmons, the second hit by pitch in this frame. Corey's all over the place. Santo Hernandez continues to warm up down the right field line with as many pitchers that have been used up by the River Sharks. You wonder when Ron Karkovic is going to dart up the dugout steps to replace Brian Corey. Maybe he's just waiting for that fifth inning to be complete and put in Santo Hernandez for a couple, starting with the sixth inning. Righty versus lefty. The first pitch to Brad Boyer is elevated. One ball and no strikes. Pedro Feliz halfway. The shortstop, Jake Igesti. The second baseman, Delwin Young, playing back, lip of the outfield grass. The 1-0. Slapped in the air, base hit left field. Playing the ball, Chris Walker. So he flicks the ball to Igesti, the relay to third base, as Simmons is 2-for-3 to spring Brad Boyer, or rather to spring Luis Figueroa. Hit by pitch for Simmons, Brad Boyer with a walk. Ron Karkovic comes to the mound, and we will see if Brian Corey's day is complete. He gives the ball to Karkovic. This ball to the bullpen is presented by Prudential Annuities. Prudential Annuities going to bat for our community. 4 2/3 innings, 8 runs allowed so far for the right-handed starter, Corey. Runners at first and second base are his responsibility. 8-0 in the top of the fifth when we return at BridgeportBluefish.com.
Why do we love baseball? Is it the uniforms, the pace of the game, the mascots? Could be. Or could it be that what we really love is that baseball reminds us how we can all come out ahead when we work together, just like a good team? At Prudential Annuities, we understand that when everyone works together, good things can happen. That's why each year, we uphold a commitment to helping charitable causes in our community by pitching in financial resources and by enabling Prudential Annuities employees to help others through volunteer work. From conducting mentoring programs and helping homeless shelters to supporting health awareness and food banks, Prudential Annuities is more than a big company in Fairfield County. We're a big part of the community, too. Prudential Annuities, going to bat for the community.
The Prudential Insurance Company of America, Newark, New Jersey, and its affiliates. Prudential Annuities is a business of Prudential Financial, Inc.
Presented by Prudential Annuities. Prudential Annuities going to bat for our community. It is Mr. Hernandez on the hill. Santo Hernandez, number 34. The final line is unofficial. 4 2/3, though, delivered by Corey. He's already given up 8 runs, 7 of which are earned. And if the Bluefish are able to score the two runs, the two runners on base, it would be 10 runs and 9 earned. One run would obviously be one more run increase, and none would keep the final line the same. Hernandez on the season with the River Sharks, just 4 games, 6 2/3 frames, 5 hits, 2 walks, 8 strikeouts. So he's done a solid job. 208 batting average against. As the second baseman, Luis Figueroa, digs in. 2 men out. James Simmons and Brad Boyer with very good speed on the base paths. So a single should score 1, a double should score 2, knowing that the runners are going on contact. The first pitch is swung on and missed. No balls and 1 strike. Do apologize, foul ball. No balls and 1 strike. Figueroa got a big swing on it. 2 men out. 8 runs on 7 hits, no runs, 1 base hit, 1 error. The right-hander delivers, the fastball planted inside, 1 ball and 1 strike. The River Sharks have had all kinds of pitching woes this year. The Bluefish had for much of the year, but of late they've been much better. Starting rotation ERA in the 4-8 range compared with where it was earlier. The pitch is stroked in the direction of Chris Walker, who makes the catch for the final out of the frame. But the Bluefish send 4 more runners to the plate. They bat around, and the Bluefish lead 8-0 at the end of 4.5. Stay tuned. You're listening to Bluefish Baseball on BridgeportBluefish.com.
Screwdriver, golf tee from the golf trip that you never went golfing on. Grill fork, tuning fork, fork fork, drumsticks, a motel key. Let's not talk about the motel key. Needle nose pliers, a spark plug, a domino, a house key. There's lots of things you can use to open the new Miller Lite Punch Top can, but you'll always get the same thing. A smooth pour with less glug. However you punch it, it's Miller time. Miller Brewing Company, Milwaukee, Wisconsin. Great beer, great responsibility. Shark tooth, screwdriver, skeleton key, golf tee from the golf trip that you never went golfing on, grill fork, tuning fork, fork fork, the lucky fishing lure you snagged Alan with, sorry Alan, drumsticks, chopsticks from the place you met that Dallas-based flight attendant, a motel key, let's not talk about the motel key, a spark plug, a domino, a house key. How do these things make Miller Lite from a can even better? Find out May 2012. Miller Brewing Company, Milwaukee, Wisconsin. Great beer, great responsibility.
Behind everything you're searching for is something you're actually looking for. When you flip through the real yellow pages for a plumber, you're actually looking to reclaim your home from a renegade faucet. It's not just getting directions to a tailor with YP.com. It's looking your best for an interview. And it's more than finding a mechanic with YP.com on your mobile. It's getting your road trip back on track. Whatever it might be, there are more ways to search and more ways to find exactly what you're looking for with the real yellow pages, YP.com, and YP.com on your mobile, only from AT&T. Behind everything you're searching for is something you're actually looking for. When you search with the real yellow pages, you get more than a contractor. You get a whole new curb appeal. It's not just getting directions to a dry cleaner with YP.com. It's rescuing an old favorite from the back of the closet. And it's more than finding a locksmith with YP.com on your mobile. It's getting to sleep in your own bed. Whatever it might be, there are more ways to search and more ways to find exactly what you're looking for with the real yellow pages, YP.com, and YP.com on your mobile, only from AT&T.
We welcome you back to the Bluefish Broadcast Network. Matt Pike is on the mound for another inning, his 5th of the game. The River Sharks are in trouble. Brian Corey was projected to start today. He did. And he finished with a final line of 4 2/3 frames with 7 hits allowed, 8 runs, 7 earned. He cannot win it, he can lose it. And the Bluefish, they did not strike out much against Brian Corey, and they walked, I believe they walked once. We'll get to that line in just a moment on BridgeportBluefish.com. But the final line for Corey, not pretty, as the first batter in the frame is Raul Padron. The first pitch planted low, 1 ball and no strikes. Final line for Corey, 4 2/3, 8 runs, 7 earned, 7 hits, a walk, and a strikeout. But he also hit 2 batters, and that influenced some of the results today. The 1-0 from Pike to Padron, who's 0-for-1. Ground ball towards third. Next pitch floats high. 2 balls, no strikes. The reason River Sharks are in trouble is because they just found out some disheartening news that the 2 starters that are expected to go tomorrow and on Sunday have been placed on the disabled list. The 2-0 is grounded to the right side. It scoots through for a base hit. It is a single for Padron to spring Eduardo Perez. So the projected pitchers also change, as no Eddie Camacho, no Keith Weezer over the next 2 days. Camacho with a calf and Weezer with an elbow. Mike McGuire is the only one that sticks in there. And the River Sharks are going to have to find a series of pieces to try to put this thing together and maybe defeat the Bluefish. This is the game that the River Sharks were hoping not to go too far into their bullpen. The first pitch is over the middle of the plate for a strike, 0-1, if the two players got hurt. No balls and one strike. 8-0 Fish. Padron, not much speed off of first. The next toss swerves inside. 1-1. Pike has kept his pitch count down. Not as many strikes today that he normally throws. 29 strikes as the pitch is chopped right back to the mound. Pike fields and flips the second one onto first. Double play. It was a close play because it took a little bit of time for the shortstop Rogers to grab the ball from his glove. He bobbled it momentarily, but was able to corral and fire a dart. DP163. Pike turns it. It's the second double play of the game as Alvin Colina digs in. So far today, all the damage being done from the middle of the order. 4 ribbies, Otanez, 3 ribbies, Simmons, 4 and 6 batters. The 2-out release is a fastball inside, 1-0. If you want to even get more general, all the hits have been from 2 to 7 tonight. Nothing from leadoff 8 or 9 from the Bluefish. Lopez has been relatively quiet. The 1-0, slap foul to the right, 1-1. Just 2 hits for the River Sharks today. Padron and Agusti. Colina flew out to left in the third. 1-1. Simmons way back. Center field on the warning track. The 1-1. Backdoor breaking ball inside. 2-1. Whenever the Bluefish have a large lead early, they like to play deep. Simmons is one of the center fielders that plays very deep in the outfield. The 2-1 is served foul to the right. 2-2. The ballpark tends to play in that direction as well. Outfielders tend to play deeper in this venue than they do in any other. 2-2. Colina is a former big leaguer, had a cup of coffee with the Rockies. The 2-2 is sent down the right field line, but the surge is sent out of play. 2-2. We thank everybody for tuning in tonight to the Bluefish Broadcast Network. Perry Miles with you. For more information about Bluefish baseball, you go to the website, bridgeportbluefish.com. You can send me an email, perrym86@gmail.com. Answer any questions that you have. Bluefish playoff possibilities is one topic. The 2-2 is grounded towards short. Diving attempt by Rogers, but it sneaks by his glove into left center field. Simmons plays the ball. It is a single for Colina. It springs Jake Agusti. Nice attempt, nice effort, but did not come up with the ball. Had he done so, Colina's not fleet of foot. Rogers would have had a chance to throw him out at first. Colina's not stealing a base. He has not done so against the Bluefish this year. Colina on the regular year has not even attempted a steal. 59 games as the first pitch is a strike over the outside corner. 0-1. Colina danced off of first as he was attempting to go towards second. Pike is a very quick move towards first, but he's not even bothering. The 0-1 is inside, 1-1. With an 8-0 leading with Colina's speed documented by Pike's lack of concern for it. Why should Pike throw to first and try to pick him off? No reason to. 1-1. Swung on and missed, high cheese. A ball and 2.
The Bluefish have had so much success at this ballpark over the last few years. Especially in 2011, 2012. One point, the Bluefish had won 13 games in a row at Campbell's Field. From the end of 2010 to most of 2011 until the final game, the next pitch is blocked in the dirt. Two balls and two strikes. The Bluefish are 4-2 at Campbell's Field this year. Take that into the equation. 4-2 plus 13-1. 17-3 in their last 20 at this ballpark as the 2-2 is chased for strike three. And they're aiming for 18 wins in the last 21 at Campbell's. The Bluefish lead 8-0, even though there were a couple of base hits in the frame. Pike able to escape with a scoreless fifth. You're listening to Bluefish Baseball on BridgeportBluefish.com.
Jimmy Rollins talks about the Baseball Hall of Fame.
Just being in the same place that all these great ball players, you know, reside at now, their career, you go find their stats, their jerseys, their helmets, their cleats, and have something of mine, that is something that anybody that goes to the Hall of Fame can see.
Preserving history, honoring excellence, connecting generations. At the National Baseball Hall of Fame and Museum in Cooperstown, New York. Connect with Cooperstown at baseballhall.org.
Hey kids, it's not too late to join BB and all of his friends by becoming a member of the Bluefish Snappers Club. The Snappers Club is the newest club for all of the biggest or littlest Bluefish fans. As a member of the Snappers Club, you'll not only get free entrance on Snappers Club Day, but you'll also get a membership card to show all of your friends, plus a special t-shirt that will tell everyone you're a member of the club. After each Sunday home game, Baseball Bunch members will also be invited onto the field to run the bases, just like the Bluefish do. You'll even receive a newsletter that will fill you in on all of your favorite Bluefish players, along with all the news that BB Snappers Club has to offer. To join the coolest club around, call 203-345-4800 or go to BridgeportBluefish.com/kids/snappers to become a member of BB's Snappers Club.
Hey Bluefish fans, have you heard about the clubhouse? Conveniently located in Fairfield, it has an unparalleled team of baseball and softball instructors offering private instruction, camps, team training, rentals, and best of all, the chance to learn from an all-pro team including Mike Porzio, former MLB pitcher, and the Bluefish's very own Willie Upshaw. Open 7 days a week, stop in and meet our team, or call us 203-292-8700 and visit us at the web, theclubhouseCT.com, and get the major league experience.
We welcome you back to the Bluefish broadcast. Perry Miles with you. The top of the sixth inning is upon us. Santo Hernandez is on the hill for his second inning of work. He retired the final batter of the frame in the fifth as he winds, kicks, and releases. Pitch lifted foul to the upper deck. No balls and one strike.
Ladies and gentlemen, right now, lower top door.
Make sure you watch out for any flying baseballs, flying bats, or broken bats. We always preach safety on the Bluefish broadcast, whether you're at a Little League game or professional game, Major League Baseball game. Doesn't matter what sporting event. The 0-1, fastball upstairs, one ball and one strike. Santo Hernandez seems to have a 91, 92 mile per hour fastball out of the bullpen. Seems to have done a solid job as the right-hander weighs in. The next toss from Hernandez, slider to the outside corner, one ball, one strike. An update from Skeeter Country, Clemens, two scoreless innings, one hit, one strikeout. The Skeeters lead 3-0 on a bases clearing double from Josh Presley. I believe it's a double. Josh Presley doubles in the run. And it was three unearned runs given up by Randy Kiesler. The 2-2, another foul ball to the right. Two balls and two strikes. Roger Clemens, 21 pitches through two innings. Cody Clemens, who signed for a day to, Kobe Clemens rather, who signed for a day to catch his dad. One of the few times in baseball history that that's happened. The 2-2 is low, 3 balls and 2 strikes, where son has caught father. So far, Clemens doing the job. Kobe Clemens, though, batting fifth, and he's 0 for 1 today. 3 balls and 2 strikes. Nobody out. The right-hander delivers. Chopped into the ground to the left side. It appears to be a base hit, and it is. It was a slow roller towards third, and Angel Flores beats it out. No chance for Pedro Feliz. He was playing back, anticipating Flores would not have a swinging bunt. More of a sharp ground ball, maybe a line drive in his direction. Nothing that Feliz could do. Good range and a solid arm. And a good at-bat put together by Flores to fight off all those pitches to wind up on base. Does not matter how you get on, just as long as you do. The next toss, fastball scales high, 1 ball and no strikes. The Bluefish have done a great job tonight driving in those runners with runners in scoring position, especially with the homers. Next toss, fastball up, 2 balls and no strikes. Teams are not going to win all the time by hitting home runs. Even the Yankees had a little bit of a struggle when they started hitting shot after shot after shot, because if the pitchers don't give up home runs, then you don't score much. The 2-0, fastball down the middle, 2-1. Jones has reached base once. He is 0-for-2 with a walk. We'll get to the major league update shortly, as Hernandez delivers and the pitch settles outside and low, 3 balls and 1 strike. So Santo Hernandez not locating his pitches very well. The Yankees leading the Baltimore Orioles now 7-3 in the bottom of the sixth. Orioles seem to be fighting back against the new arch rival. Next pitch, swung on and missed, 3 balls and 2 strikes. Baltimore had so many high picks in the first round, and those high first-round draft choices are paying dividends. Look at the way that the Rays had built up all their first-round draft picks. And they're a perennial contender with their outstanding pitching. A 3-2 is swung on and missed. Strike three. Kennard Jones goes down hacking. One away as Eddie Rogers digs in. The Mets trail the Braves 1-0 at the end of 5. The Red Sox down to the Blue Jays, 1-0 at the end of 1. Big news in the NFL today. And this is such an interesting turn of events, because it may influence the culture of football. I'm sure many fans enjoy their football, and they'll be seeing the Eagles game this weekend. As the first pitch is a fastball inside, 1 ball and no strikes. Eagles opening week is coming up Sunday. And the Giants played earlier this week. They lost to the Cowboys 24-17. But the Saints won their appeal of the bounty scandal. The players did. The 1-0, fastball high, 2 balls and no strikes. The players' intent is to hit hard. The idea behind Roger Goodell was to eliminate injuries such as concussions, post-concussion syndrome, vertigo, other head trauma injuries. The 2-0, slap foul to the netting, 2 balls and 1 strike. And by this being overturned, obviously, Coach Payton has been suspended. The interim coach, Joe Vitt, for New Orleans, has been suspended for 6 games. But eventually he'll take over. In the end, the players will still hit each other as hard as they did before. And the culture still may go on, even with discouragement, as the pitch is grabbed to short. Eigenstein flips the second, 1 onto first, double play.
That ends the inning on the 6-4-3. DP will continue with that point right after the break. Bottom of the sixth coming up. Bridgeport with an 8-0 lead. You're listening to Bluefish Baseball on BridgeportBluefish.com.
Jimmy Rollins talks about the Baseball Hall of Fame.
Just being in the same place that all these great ball players, you know, reside at now, their career, you go find their stats, their jerseys, their helmets, their cleats, and have something of mine, that is something that anybody that goes to the Hall of Fame can see.
Preserving history, honoring excellence, connecting generations. At the National Baseball Hall of Fame and Museum in Cooperstown, New York. Connect with Cooperstown at baseballhall.org.
Why do we love baseball? Is it the uniforms, the pace of the game, the mascots? Could be. Or could it be that what we really love is that baseball reminds us how we can all come out ahead when we work together, just like a good team? At Prudential Annuities, we understand that when everyone works together, good things can happen. That's why each year, we uphold a commitment to helping charitable causes in our community by pitching in financial resources and by enabling Prudential Annuities employees to help others through volunteer work. From conducting mentoring programs and helping homeless shelters to supporting health awareness and food banks, Prudential Annuities is more than a big company in Fairfield County. We're a big part of the community, too. Prudential Annuities, going to bat for the community.
The Prudential Insurance Company of America, Newark, New Jersey, and its affiliates. Prudential Annuities is a business of Prudential Financial, Inc.
This is Terry McGriff, pitching coach for the Bridgeport Bluefish, and you listen to Perry Miles on the Bluefish broadcast.
The Bluefish Broadcast Network is back. Perry Miles with you. As the right-hander Matt Pike remains on the hill, there's more bullpen activity as Santo Hernandez tosses an inning and a third. It appears as if the River Sharks are going to be going to the bullpen again for the seventh inning. Matt Pike throws his final warm-up pitch. There is nobody warming up in the Bluefish bullpen. He has had tremendous command of his off-speed pitches tonight. We do apologize for any technical difficulties that we may have had on the Bluefish broadcast tonight. As Pike weighs in, has the signal, and receives the glove, tilts, so does his leg. The first pitch is a fastball, lined up on the inside, missed the corner, one ball and no strikes. Campbell's Field, Camden, New Jersey, what a sight. You can see the causeway as the pitch is lifted down the left field line, foul. And if we just tilt this up for a moment, maybe a little bit higher, you can tell that there are some almost resembling that of Christmas lights, green and blue lights on the top. You can see down the center. One ball and one strike with nobody out. Pike delivers, fastball low, two balls and one strike. So the Skeeters out to a 3-0 lead. We talked about the Southern Maryland Blue Crabs, they're ahead of their game, but the Yankees and local baseball and the change of the culture in the NFL, just number of elements as a panel vacates the bounties, fines and suspensions against the players. The 2-1 lands in the dirt, three balls and one strike. Jonathan Vilma and Will Smith, two of the players on the Saints, have been cleared to play rather than serving all kinds of suspensions. Go figure. The 3-1 fastball high for ball four. Delwyn Young walks. It springs Reed Gorecki. And I'm sure the players are happy. Now the question is whether or not the coaches have been affected. And it appears that Sean Payton has been suspended for the season. Joe Vitt for 6 games and general manager Mickey Loomis for 8 games for their involvement. Because they were the catalysts to paying to get hurt in that regard. The players executed the plan, but it's not as if they were going to go against their coach's wishes. The next toss, righty versus righty, as Grecki lets a first pitch go for a strike on the inside corner. Nothing in one. So that's one of the big stories of the day, that the bounties got overturned. Another big story on the night, as another floater, curve low, one ball and one strike, is women's tennis. Maria Sharapova's out. The number one seed Azarenka moves on. Serena Williams versus Azarenka in the U.S. Open Finals. The 1-1 is poked out to deep left center field. James Simmons on a dead sprint. He won't get there. He has to play it towards the wall. Rounding third and coming towards the plate. Delwyn Young, the throw, gets away from the shortstop Eddie Rogers, but there's no advance. It's an RBI double for Reed Gorecki, and the River Sharks have scored their first run of the day. It is an 8-1 ball game. That was a nice piece of hitting towards the left center field gap by Gorecki. Took a pitch up in the zone, and many times when there is a leadoff walk, comes to cost the team. So Pike's shutout is over on the fourth base hit of the evening for the River Sharks. The next offering from Pike, grounded foul to the right. No balls and one strike. Other headlines besides tennis. Quite a few. Savannah State playing against Florida State saw the shellacking this past weekend that they suffered against Oklahoma State. Savannah State, a 69.5 point underdog at Florida State. The money is there for Savannah State, but boy, those players could get injured severely. The 0-1 is inside, one ball and one strike. Think about it this way. It's as if a mid-level tier Division II basketball team, the likes of a Queens College, is going up against Kentucky. They don't belong on the same floor. 1-1 lifted foul to the left. One ball and two strikes. It's like taking LeBron James, putting him on the floor against a Division I college player, a mid-level Division I college player. Who do you think is going to win that matchup? Nobody's guarding LeBron. The 1-2 from Pike. Gorecki off of second. The next pitch, a line drive. Base hit towards left center field. Gorecki rounds third. He's coming to the plate as Kennard Jones fields and throws to second. It's offline. It is an RBI double for Walker, and the River Sharks have scored the first two runs of the ball game on back-to-back doubles by Gorecki and Walker. Brian Bergamy digs in. It's an 8-2 ball game. Pike through five scoreless frames, and now he cannot seem to record now. He has given up a walk and back-to-back doubles. There is no activity right now in the Bluefish bullpen. The Bluefish would like to get more out of Pike. The right-hander stares in. The pitch, ground ball to the right side. Figueroa corrals and throws to first in time. One away on the 4-3 with Walker moving to third. Pedro Feliz digs in. Pitchers toss differently when they are ahead by as many runs as they are. 8-0 game. A pitcher is designated to throw the ball over the plate, throw the strikes. They should be doing that all the time, but when it's closer, there's greater command. When it's a little bit further away, the first pitch is outside, one ball, no strikes. There's a little bit less to worry about. Even though And they should be pitching the same way. The 1-0 is on the inside corner for a strike. One ball, one strike. It's not a lackadaisical approach. That's the wrong way to describe it. Pitching to the score might be more appropriate. The 1-1, fastball away, two balls and a strike. First four innings went swimmingly. Last couple, not as much. Next toss, outside. Two balls becomes three balls and one strike.
How do you say I am blank here?
Right-hander Pike stares in, gets the signal, pitch is grounded to short. The run will score. Rogers throws the first, RBI 6-3 to make it 8-3. 6-3 on the putout as Raul Padron digs in.
The catcher, number 23, Raul.
And it's all because of the leadoff walk leading to back-to-back doubles. Raul Padron, a single and a 5-3. Still no action in the Bluefish bullpen. That was a relatively quick shift. More than 80 pitches delivered by Pike as the first toss is outside. One ball and no strikes. Throw a majority in the strike zone, but his command, his percentage of strikes down. The 1-0 popped up to the left side. Veers out of play as Boyer scampers after it, but watches it fall to the seats. 1-1. We thank you for tuning in to BridgeportBluefish.com tonight. Perry Miles with you on this hazy, hot, and humid night from New Jersey, just east of Philadelphia. The 1-1. Slap foul to the left, a ball and two strikes. Plenty of activity today. Sugar Land and Long Island. In the duel, it's still 3-0. Clemens with 3 1/3 innings of one hit, one strikeout baseball. Around the same pitch count that he was against the Bluefish. The only hit provided by Matt Esquivel. The 1-2, way inside, two balls, two strikes. Do not know what Clemens' pitch count is. What his limit would be. Two balls, two strikes. The light fixtures where the Ben Franklin Causeway just turned colors from blue and green to red. Beautiful. One hop over to second on a ground ball. The throw to first is in time for the final out of the sixth inning. Three run score on two base hits. Nobody left on. End of six. Bridgeport with an 8-3 lead. You're listening to Bluefish Baseball on BridgeportBluefish.com.
Behind everything you're searching for is something you're actually looking for. When you search with the real Yellow Pages, you get more than a contractor. You get a whole new curb appeal. It's not just getting directions to a dry cleaner with YP.com. It's rescuing an old favorite from the back of the closet. And it's more than finding a locksmith with YP.com on your mobile. It's getting to sleep in your own bed. Whatever it might be, there are more ways to search and more ways to find exactly what you're looking for with the real Yellow Pages, YP.com, and YP.com on your mobile, only from AT&T.
A sizzling, succulent filet mignon, scrumptious salmon Florentine, savory twin grilled pork chops. Getting hungry? Your table awaits at the Park City Grill, Fairfield County's elegant new dining spot in the beautifully renovated Bridgeport Holiday Inn. Comfortable, warm, and inviting, Park City Grill offers a world-class dining experience at reasonable prices. Come to the Park City Grill, 1070 Main Street in the Bridgeport Holiday Inn. Take I-95 exit 27A to exit 2. Plenty of free, secure parking.
Baseball legend Henry Aaron reflects on his Hall of Fame legacy.
I think that since I played for the public, they need to share what I did in my life as far as baseball. It's the proudest moment of my life to give everything to the Hall of Fame. I often tell people they need to get and see it. There is no other building in the world like the Hall of Fame in baseball.
Celebrate the game. Celebrate the legacy. Connect with Cooperstown at baseballhall.org. Mike Piazza talks about the Baseball Hall of Fame.
It just connects you with the history of the game and the tradition of this game and how far, how important this game is to the fabric of society. It's something I use to bond with my father, and I will always, and I love to sort of teach my kids the history of baseball.
Preserving history, honoring excellence, connecting generations. Connect with Cooperstown at baseballhall.org.
Bridgeport Bluefish Baseball is back. This call to the bullpen is presented by Prudential Annuities. Prudential Annuities going to bat for our community. Spencer Steedley is on the hill. Left-handed pitcher, some affiliated baseball experience, making his way to the mound another time. 38 games this year for Steedley. 3 wins and 1 loss, an ERA about 4.5, 4.46. 40 and a third innings. He's batting, his opponents are batting 230 on the year. And he struck out 20, so he's not a strikeout pitcher, but he has provided some quality outings against the Bluefish in the past out of the bullpen. And the Bluefish will send up Prentice Redmond, Willis Otañez, and Luis Lopez, 3, 4, and 5 in the order for the Bluefish. We are past the 9 o'clock hour in Camden, New Jersey, Campbell's Field, as the southpaw Steedley stares in, swings his hand like a pendulum for a moment. The next toss, fastball away, 1 ball and no strikes. Many fans making their way out to the ballpark. Believe there is a fireworks display as the next pitch is roped foul to the left. 1 ball and 1 strike. There is a fireworks display following the conclusion of this ball game. Post-game show is coming up as well. The Bluefish hoping that York is able to put up some offense. They have not been able to do that. The fastball races high. And the count, 2 balls and 1 strike. Hey, Bluefish fans, would you like your own personalized jersey to be worn by your favorite Bluefish player during the last homestand of the regular season? Contact Bobby at extension 125 by calling 203-345-4800. The 2-1 is served into deep left field, but playable for the corner outfielder Chris Walker. One away in the frame. An F7 for Redmond as Willis Otañez digs in. A grand slam for Otañez in the fifth inning. That opened up a big lead for the Bluefish. Pike allowed 3 runs in the sixth inning. That may be all for the right-hander. We'll have to wait and find out. Bottom of the seventh from Baltimore, the Yankees now leading only by 3 runs. It's 7-4. The one-out delivery is a ground ball sharply struck to short, gathered by Agusti. He has plenty of time and throws to first, 2 out. 6-3 for Otañez. Luis Lopez digs in. Another Atlantic League scoreboard update. Courtesy of PointStreak.com and AtlanticLeague.com.
First baseman number 19, Luis Lopez.
Luis Lopez stands in. The Revolution have come back. It's a 5-2 lead for York in the top half of the sixth inning. A Bluefish win coupled with a Southern Maryland loss pushes the Bluefish even closer as the next toss is over the middle of the plate. No balls and 1 strike. Bridgeport maintains the lead. Nick Green got smacked around. 5 2/3 innings of 5 run, 8 hit, 1 walk, 5 strikeout baseball. The pitch is smacked. Foul, left field line out of play. No balls and 2 strikes. Brandon Hoffman, 2 RBI. Limonta, who's a new member of the Revolution, has scored a run. RBI for Fiorentino, Hernandez, and Nowak. RBI for Barton and Gutierrez for the Blue Crabs. 2 of 3 players with multiple hit games
so far. The pitch is sent towards the middle of the diamond, gathered by the second baseman, Delwin Young, as he throws out Lopez at first for a 1-2-3 seventh. Seventh inning stretch time. The Bluefish lead 8-3. Stay tuned. You're listening to Bluefish Baseball on BridgeportBluefish.com. We'll be right back after these words from your local sponsors. Stay tuned.
Join the Bluefish for a playoff push in 2012. The Bluefish have great options from picnics and birthday parties to harbor club outings and sweet leases. Invite your friends, family, or coworkers out to the ballpark for an exciting night of affordable family fun. Kids celebrating a birthday party at the ballpark will get an autographed baseball, a visit from BB the Bluefish, and much, much more, including a chance to compete in the best on-field promotions Connecticut has to offer. Don't miss out on the final home games of the regular season. Book your outing with the Bluefish today. Call 203-345-4800 to schedule an unforgettable day at the ballpark in Harbor Yard during the 15th anniversary season, or go to BridgeportBluefish.com. Bridgeport Bluefish Baseball. Get hooked.
The best way to brighten up your home is to do just that. Brighten it up. To illuminate and decorate. The exciting lighting ideas come from Valley Lighting and Home Decor. Your home becomes your showplace when you let it shine with designer lighting so distinctive it is clearly a work of art. Valley Lighting and Home Decor is set to bedazzle you with glittering crystal chandeliers and lamps. Treasures abound in unique home accents, special touches, just the right things to bring your whole decor together. Because your home is not just what's inside the four walls, brighten up your garden, your deck, and your pool area with outdoor landscape lighting. This is the season to invigorate, radiate, celebrate, rejuvenate. The brightest ideas begin here at Connecticut's largest lighting and home decor showplace. Illuminate and decorate at Valley Lighting and Home Decor on Chestnut Street in Ansonia, just a minute off Route 8, exit 16.
Broadcast Network is back. Perry Miles here, and the right-hander on the hill for his seventh inning, Matt Pike, as the right-hander has his focus towards the plate. The first pitch swung on and fouled off. No balls and one strike. The first batter, Eduardo Perez. The second one, due up, Alvin Colina. The third one, Jake Eigenstein. York with a 5-2 lead now over Southern Maryland. Bluefish win coupled with a York Revolution victory as the next toss flattens high, one ball, one strike. The Bluefish would gain a game. They're only 4.5 back of Southern Maryland with still quite a few games to play, including three in a head-to-head matchup. The 1-1 slap foul to the left side, one ball and two strikes. In Major League Baseball, we have seen quite a few collapses down the stretch. The Red Sox and the Braves last year, the Philadelphia Phillies a few years back, the New York Mets a few years back, back-to-back years, and the Philadelphia Phillies accomplishing that. One ball and two strikes with nobody out. Bluefish have 17 possible games after tonight as the next toss is a fastball rotating high, two balls and two strikes. The best guess, the Bluefish would need to pick up 39 wins, be 39-30, or 38-31 as the 2-2 is inside, three balls and two strikes, possibly 38-31 in order to at least have a play-in game for the postseason. Three balls and two strikes. Pike lifts his leg and delivers. Swung on and chopped foul to the netting. Three balls, two strikes.
Ladies and gentlemen, the winner of the Roxborough Rebels
scooter raffle is ticket number 176844.
Southern Maryland last year came to the ballpark at Harbor Yard and stunned the Bluefish with the guy on the mound pitching for the Bluefish in that play-in game. The 3-2. A bouncer to the right side. Figueroa gathers on two hops, throws to Lopez at first, one away. 4-3 for Perez. Alvin Colina digs in. Quite a few offensive bursts from these teams. But the Bluefish made more noise tonight so far. Four runs in the fourth, four runs in the fifth. The River Sharks, one blemish on Pike's record, that three spot in the sixth. One out delivery, tucked over the inside corner and a backdoor breaker. No balls and one strike. Chris Waters, Nick Green in that matchup between York and Southern Maryland. And quite a few other activities taking place. Lancaster and Somerset for the Bluefish has almost no significance. The pitch is spanked at the right field. It heads towards the corner for an extra base hit as Redmond digs it out of the corner. Alvin Colina is on with his second hit of the day as Jake Eigenstein moves in.
Shortstop number 9, Jake Eigenstein.
As Eigenstein is 1-for-2 today with a single and a strikeout. The Barnstormers have been dominating on and off the field. And you wonder at what point they will stop. The Barnstormers lead the Patriots 5-2. Somerset is in a load of trouble. They are far back of the wild card and they really have no shot at the division either. With 14 to play after tonight, they might be 10 and a half back in the division. There is almost no shot as the pitch is lined to the center field. It's a base hit. James Simmons comes up throwing as the runner is held up. Throw is cut off by Luis Lopez. And that may have been one of the final pitches for Pike. There appears to be some stretching down the left field line for the Bluefish, but nothing imminent. Back-to-back line drives. Right field corner, Colina. Center field, Eigesty, as Willie Upshaw makes his way to the mound. Delwin Young is coming to the plate. Going to allow Pike to continue in this game. But there appears to be activity brewing with Luis Rodriguez making his way down the left field line to catch a bullpen. We cannot tell who it is that's warming up. It might be Jesse English. Jesse English is down there. Jesse has become the seventh inning pitcher for the Bluefish. Julio DePaula the eighth, and Rami Lewis the ninth inning guy. With the departure of Juan Rincon and a few other pieces on this team leaving. Willie Upshaw had his conversation with Pike. A double play ball. Maybe in order for the right-hander. Delwin Young digs in. He has walked and grounded into a double play. Will the River Sharks be able to creep closer? Or will the Bluefish find a way to retire Young, maybe head to the top of the order, or perhaps to the top of the eighth? Pike's one-out toss stalls for a moment. He stepped off the rubber before he reestablishes presence on the mound on the third, towards the middle of the rubber. Brings the feet closer together, the slide step, the one out pitch swung on and missed, a changeup, 0-1. Big swing and a miss from Delwin Young.
I think they know how to hit.
Righty versus lefty. The 0-1. Fastball served outside. One ball and one strike. The Patriots 26-29. And if you look at the overall record, They have been divvied up to division leaders and wild card teams. Somerset six back of the wild card. The Bluefish desperately need to get that division. Pitch is grounded to first, foul. One ball and two strikes, which is why the Bluefish have a better chance of making the playoffs than Somerset does. York closes out. Somerset will be seven back of York, and the Bluefish four and a half back of Southern Maryland for the division. Anything's possible within a week of baseball. Southern Maryland will have three more games against York and seven against Lancaster, the team with the best record in the league. Bluefish will have scores of chances try to make up the ground. The 1-2 is poked foul to the left. The count remains at a ball and two strikes. Bluefish remaining schedule. Three more after tonight at this venue. Three at the ballpark at Harbor Yard against the Blue Crabs. Four against the Skeeters. Three against the Barnstormers. The Skeeters and Barnstormers games are at home. 1-2 blocked in the dirt on the shuffle step by Flores. Two balls, two strikes.
Okay, that's line up.
Three at Somerset. And go figure. Somerset and Southern Maryland, two teams that are competing for that playoff bid, that playoff mark. Bluefish are fighting for that. Two balls, two strikes. Whoever makes it to the postseason from the Liberty Division, as the 2-2 is sent foul to the left, is probably going to be the favorite to come out of the Liberty because of how poorly Long Island has played. Bluefish seem to have the Ducks' number this year. 12 wins and 7 losses against Long Island. Southern Maryland has toppled the flock as well. Pike waits, 2-2. Ground ball to first, gobbled up by Lopez, steps on the bag. One, throw to second, is in time, and the run does not score. A poor play by Alvin Colina, as Colina did not cross the base in time. What a lapse in judgment by Colina. He could have scored, and he hustled home, and he did not do it. The Bluefish escape without a run score, double play on the 3-6, and the Bluefish are done. No runs in the frame, two base hits, one runner left on at the end of seven. The Bluefish lead 8-3. You're listening to Bluefish Baseball on BridgeportBluefish.com.
Wants you to win the greatest weekend that never happened. The ultimate Vegas weekend for you and a buddy. Just collect Miller Lite Taste Points for your chance to win one of 100 Vegas trips being given away this summer for the big weekend. So grab Miller Lite and seize the summer at tastepoints.com. It's that easy, and it never happened. It's Miller time. No purchase necessary. Open to legal U.S. residents 21 or older. Void in California and where prohibited. Sweepstakes begins 5-1-12 and ends 8-1-12. For details, how to enter and complete official rules, go to tastepoints.com. Miller Brewing Company, Milwaukee, Wisconsin. Great beer, great responsibility.
Miller time. Don't check your wrist or follow up with your supervisor, because Miller time has nothing to do with when and everything to do with who.
What's up, Tommy?
Miller Lite is brewed for the guys you're proud to call your brothers. We'll always talk you out of getting that faux hawk and never talk.
Nice.
During your backswing. And when you've got your brothers and the light beer that tastes like a beer should, it's not just a good time, it's Miller time.
Great beer, great responsibility. Miller Brewing Company, Milwaukee, Wisconsin.
Shark tooth, screwdriver, golf tee from the golf trip that you never went golfing on, grill fork, tuning fork, fork fork, drumsticks, a motel key. Let's not talk about the motel key. Needle nose pliers, a spark plug, a domino, a house key. There's lots of things you can use to open the new Miller Lite Punch Top Can, but you'll always get the same thing. A smooth pour with less glug. However you punch it, it's Miller time. Miller Brewing Company, Milwaukee, Wisconsin. Great beer, great responsibility.
Why do we love baseball? Is it the uniforms, the pace of the game, the mascots? Could be. Or could it be that what we really love is that baseball reminds us how we can all come out ahead when we work together? Just like a good team. At Prudential Annuities, we understand that when everyone works together, good things can happen. That's why each year, we uphold a commitment to helping charitable causes in our community by pitching in financial resources. work. From conducting mentoring programs and helping homeless shelters to supporting health awareness and food banks, Prudential Annuities is more than a big company in Fairfield County. We're a big part of the community, too. Prudential Annuities, going to bat for the community.
The Prudential Insurance Company of America, Newark, New Jersey, and its affiliates. Prudential Annuities is a business of Prudential Financial, Inc.
We welcome you back to the Bluefish Broadcast Network. Spencer Steedley in for his second inning of work. The first pitch, fastball upstairs, one ball and no strikes. That was one of the worst plays I have ever seen mentally from a team the entire season. Runners at the corners will go reconfigure the motion as the pitch is lifted in the air or redraw up the play as the right fielder, Brian Bergamy, moves in and makes the play for the first out of the frame. We'll give you another picture of what happened. Runners at first and third. There's a ground ball to first. Lopez does the right thing, steps on the bag. Colleen is not hustling. He's assuming that Lopez is going to go 3-6-3. He thinks it's going to be a double play. So Lopez steps on the bag, which automatically eliminates a forced play, which means that the runner from third can easily score, and Colleen is not hustling, so he doesn't come to the plate. In addition to that, the runner at first base did not try to get into a rundown, Jake Eichesty. The first pitch is planted on the outside corner, 0-1. Eichesty slides into second base, gets tagged out before Colina can score. Rather than getting into a rundown, allowing another run to come across, the 0-1 slides inside, one ball and one strike. That is one of the worst plays by a team between two of its players. Not just one, two. The 1-1 from the lefty. Foul tipped into the glove, a ball and two strikes. They always say to preach the fundamentals. Hustle. Think before you act. Camden did not follow those two simple fundamentals. The 1-2 is inside, two balls and two strikes. In life, it's about hustle, going after it. Same in baseball, 2-2. Steely plants it low, three balls and two strikes. Bluefish don't care. They got to have Matt Pike throw seven innings a three-run ball. And it was really strong, especially the first five. The 3-2 is a bouncer foul to the right. Three balls and two strikes. Brad Boyer, two hits tonight. Three multiple hit games for the Bluefish. Eddie Rogers, Brad Boyer, and... two multiple hit games. Next toss is upstairs, ball four. Two multiple hit games as Boyer reaches on a walk. Luis Figueroa digs in. Brad Boyer's reached for the third time tonight. Luis Figueroa looking for his first hit of the night. The Bluefish postgame show is coming up following the conclusion of this ball game. It is the top of the eighth inning with one man out. You may see Pike in for the eighth inning, but he, I believe, went over the 100 pitch mark. Seven innings will do for Pike after the way that the Bluefish offense was able to put a big piece of energy forward. The pitch is lifted foul to the right, 0-1. They were able to provide him with so much run support. No complaints today. Good baseball from the Bluefish tonight. And they did not commit an error again. They have committed the second fewest errors. And because Boyer's moved over to third, their double play combination has been that much better. As the pitch is roped foul down the left field line. No balls and two strikes. The 0-2 from the southpaw.
Figueroa awaits the pitch. Line drive, base hit past third, where Feliz was. Runners at first and second for Angel Flores. Angel Flores is the pizza man, but he is not, he has not been helpful for the River Sharks fans. One man out, 8 runs, 9 base hits. 3 runs, 7 base hits, 1 error. Steedley waits, the next toss, floats outside, 1 ball and no strikes. .932 on the East Coast. Past the 2.5 hour mark from Campbell's Field in Camden, New Jersey, the 1-0. Fastball goes high, 2 balls and no strikes. Adam Thomas is in the game for York. 5-2 contest. York scored 2 runs in the 5th and 3 more in the 6th. Cats for their offense. Meanwhile, in Sugarland, great outing so far as the pitch is inside. 3 balls, no strikes. Clemens goes 4 2/3 innings as replaced by Jeff Farnsworth. 2 hits and a strikeout. Clemens building up that stamina. Who knows, maybe the next time he'll go 6. The 3-0, well outside ball 4. So far, Clemens, 8 innings of scoreless baseball in the Atlantic League. Still probably feels that he's not where he needs to be.
Left fielder number 23, Kennard Jones.
Kennard Jones digs in. The bases are loaded for the Bluefish with one man out. A chance for Bridgeport to open up this game. Lefty versus lefty. Steedley against Jones. Who wins? One out toss, swung on and missed. Early advantage to Steedley, 0-1. The hits, Esquivel and Navarrete. But Sugarland, 7 hits and 3 runs. The 0-1. Floats inside, 1 ball and 1 strike. There's a different mindset whenever Clemens goes to the hill. And the team seems to pitch much better when he's out there. He's that kind of commanding figure. The 1-1 floats over the middle, 1 ball and 2 strikes. Beautiful night. A decent crowd for a Friday from Campbell's Field, Camden, New Jersey. The 1-2, a breaking ball low, 2 balls and 2 strikes. Consecutive doubles by Reed Gorecki and Chris Walker led to 2 runs being driven in after Delwin Young reached on a walk. 2-2, lands low, 3 balls, 2 strikes, nowhere to put Jones. The Bluefish scored a run, an unearned run, on an error of E5 by Luis Lopez. So Pedro Feliz committed the miscue, the 3-2. Oh, he could not strike 3. 2 away as Eddie Rogers digs in.
Hey fans, here's the strikeout brought to you by Susquehanna Bank Strikeout the Straight A's program. Now batting shortstop number 3, Eddie Rogers.
Eddie Rogers, 2 for 4 on the night. Top of the 8th inning, bases are loaded. Center fielder Reed Gorecki angling towards left center. The southpaw digging in, the 2-out pitch, fastball inside, 1 ball and no strikes.
activity down the right field line for the River Sharks. They'll have another string of long games tomorrow and the following day. Next pitch, floater high. Two balls, no strikes. Appears to be James Hauser down the left, the right field line, the southpaw. Two balls, no strikes. Two men out, fastball way outside. Three balls, no strikes. Spencer Steedley may be in line to give up an earned run, making 9-3, a bases loaded walk. Bluefish love it. They'd like to extend the lead even more. To give some of their arms, perhaps Juan El Mesa gets his Bluefish debut tonight. 3-0. Fastball, outside ball four. Steedley walks, the bases loaded as the run comes home. That's an RBI for Rogers. Boyer steps on the plate. It's 9-3. The two-out delivery is coming up to Prentice Redmond, who's reached base twice tonight. The two-out serving is over the middle of the plate, no balls and one strike. Campbell's Field in Camden, New Jersey. For Bridgeport Bluefish Baseball and BridgeportBluefish.com, the 0-1. Outside, one ball and one strike.
Report to the information booth at this time. Chris Taxis.
Steedley in a world of trouble. Not being able to throw strikes of late. The 1-1 bends inside, two balls and a strike. Next pitch, serving near to right field. Should be playable for Brian Bergamy as he angles forward, then moves back and makes the catch for the final out of the frame. The Bluefish leave the bases loaded, but they score a run on a bases loaded walk from Eddie Rogers. The Bluefish lead 9-3 at the end of 7.5. Stay tuned, you're listening to Bluefish Baseball on BridgeportBluefish.com.
Jimmy Rollins talks about the Baseball Hall of Fame.
This being in the same place that all these great ball players, you know, reside at now, their career. You go find their stats, their jerseys, their helmets, their cleats, and have something of mine. That is something that anybody that goes to the Hall of Fame can see.
Preserving history, honoring excellence, connecting generations. At the National Baseball Hall of Fame and Museum in Cooperstown, New York. Connect with Cooperstown at baseballhall.org.
Kids, it's not too late to join BB and all of his friends by becoming a member of the Bluefish Snappers Club. The Snappers Club is the newest club for all of the biggest or littlest Bluefish fans. As a member of the Snappers Club, you'll not only get free entrance on Snappers Club Day, but you'll also get a membership card to show all of your friends, plus a special t-shirt that will tell everyone you're a member of the club. After each Sunday home game, Baseball Bunch members will also be invited onto the field to run the bases, just like the Bluefish do. You'll even receive a newsletter that will fill you in on all of your favorite Bluefish players, along with all the news that BB Snappers Club has to offer. To join the coolest club around, call 203-345-4800 or go to BridgeportBluefish.com/kids/snappers to become a member of BB's Snappers Club.
Hey, welcome back to Bluefish Broadcast. Perry Miles with you. Hey, Bluefish fans. You can choose one charity to receive money from your Bluefish Baseball Foxy ticket purchase. The three charities that receive the most votes by 9 a.m. Monday, September the 10th on the Bluefish Facebook page will receive $2 from your advanced Foxy ticket purchase for any or all games. The September 11th, September 12th, September 18th, or September 19th matchups, or $1 for each Foxy ticket you purchase at the box office on the day of the game. Also, your Foxy ticket price will be discounted $2 if you order in advance and $1 if you order at the box office. You can call 203-416-1751 or 203-416-1719 for more details. The Bluefish, they are winning by a score of 9-3. This call to the bullpen is presented by Prudential Annuities. Prudential Annuities, going to bat for our community. Jesse English, 3 wins, 3.33 ERA, 48 and two-thirds innings. Opponents hitting .222 against the left-hander. Not too shabby. He's become the setup man for this ball club. One of the setup men. He's one of the seventh-inning guy. DePaul at the eighth and Lewis the ninth. The first pitch is a fastball outside. 1 ball and no strikes. English, a California kid. His parents originally from the Dallas, Texas area. Big Cowboys fan, so he was definitely cheering on for Dallas this weekend. Especially on Wednesday night. And the two teams faced off. The 1-0 is outside. 2 balls and no strikes. English awaits, throws the fastball between 87 and 89 miles per hour, consistent basis. Next toss is outside, 3 balls, no strikes. 4 runs in the fourth, another 4 in the fifth, and 1 more in the eighth for Bridgeport. They lead 9-3, 9:43 on the East Coast for those of you tuned in. The 3-0, fastball down the middle, 3-1. The batter, Reed Gorecki, Chris Walker, and Brian Bergamy, 1, 2, and 3, due up. Pike's final line, solid. The 3-1 is chased. 3 balls and 2 strikes on a change. 7 innings, 7 hits, 3 runs for Pike. That's what he allowed on the day. 2 walks, 4 strikeouts. 3-2 is popped up to the right side of the infield. Scampering after it is Angel Flores. He throws his mask away and cannot make the catch as it may have beamed one of the players in the Camden dugout. Odd. 3 balls and 2 strikes. Nine and zero to three, seven and one. The 3-2 on its way. Swung on and missed. Strike three. Down he goes as Gorecki goes back to the seat. We want to make one correction on the Bluefish broadcast. It was not Spencer Steedley on the hill for the eighth inning. The player that gave up the run in the eighth inning was Alex Smith, a lefty. Similar statures from the left side. Steely with a scoreless inning and Smith with an inning, a hit, a run, 3 walks and a strikeout. Appears that there will be one more pitcher entering for the River Sharks in this contest. Sidewinding the lefty, the one out, toss to serve foul. Count no balls and one strike. And that's James Hauser. Game went well out of reach, at least for the time being. Never know with the game of baseball, though. You never do know. Teams have come back from 6 runs down, 7 runs down to win ball games. The 0-1 swung on and missed. No balls and two strikes. From Baltimore, the Yankees lead 8-4. So they increased their total with 1 in the ninth inning. No balls, 2 strikes with 1 man out. English continuing to take his time.
Clemens spectacle, the Clemens saga is over. The 0-2. Number foul to the netting. Walker stays alive as he's batting from the right side this time. Bluefish Broadcast would like to thank everybody for tuning in tonight. You can hear the fans in the background, but it's not quite the same kind of energy that was being displayed before. River Sharks down by 6. Fans hoping for a rally. They're gonna need a few base runners to do that as Walker goes after and whiffs for strike 3. English planted it beautifully low in the zone, 2-away. Sends up Brian Bergamy.
Number 7, Brian Bergamy.
0-2 today for Bergamy. Strikeout of 4-3 and a walk. All-American back in college for Wichita State. Made it as high as Double-A. Very difficult to make it through. Double-A for many organizations is the last step before the big leagues, even though there may be a Triple-A affiliate. The two-out delivery is fouled to the screen, 0-1. Jesse English made it to the big leagues with the Washington Nationals. The 0-1 lands inside, 1-1. Cup of coffee in the big leagues with the Nationals back in 2010. Shows how far certain players can fall. He's got some good stuff on the hill. 1-1 is sent in the air towards right center field. Moving forward and diving to make the catch is Prentice Redmond for the final out of the frame. F9 for Bergamy. The Bluefish retire the River Sharks in order in the 8th. Shift to the 9th. The Bluefish are leading 9-3. Stay tuned. You're listening to Bluefish Baseball on BridgeportBluefish.com. The Bluefish have great gifts and giveaways coming up at the ballpark at Harbor Yard, beginning with a series against the Southern Maryland Blue Crabs on September 11th. That Tuesday is Kids Eat Free, presented by Big Y World Class Market. Kids 12 and under are entitled to a hot dog, potato chips, and a fountain beverage. Wednesday is Bark in the Park Night, presented by Canine Company, followed by Thirsty Thursday, presented by Budweiser. Friday the 14th kicks off Fan Appreciation Weekend with a fireworks extravaganza presented by Sabrette. 7:05 first pitch for each game during Saturday the 15th, which is 2 7-inning games as part of a doubleheader beginning at 1 p.m. from Bridgeport. Race Pass giveaway is sponsored by Grand Prix of New York. Sunday is all about family fun as there is a kids' autograph session before the game and kids run the bases afterwards. The 2:05 first pitch on Sunday with gates opening 1 hour before each first pitch. Tickets are available for the series by going to BridgeportBluefish.com or by calling 203-345-4800. Bridgeport Bluefish Baseball. Get hooked.
The Gear Shop at the ballpark at Harbor Yard is your one-stop shop for everything Bluefish. Take a break from the action and check out all your Bluefish souvenir favorites. From men's and women's t-shirts and a wide selection of home, road, and other trendy hats, to Fear the Fin rally towels, team photos, and commemorative baseballs. The Gear Shop has it all. Don't forget about our kids' wear section, game-worn jerseys, even your own stuffed BB the Bluefish, and more. The Bluefish Gear Shop is located on the third base side of the concourse level at the ballpark at Harbor Yard and is open on game days. Come and browse all your favorite Bluefish apparel from an hour before the first pitch until the final out is made. Can't make it to the ballpark on game day, but still want to support Fairfield County's only professional baseball team? Then check out the new Bluefish online store at BridgeportBluefish.com or call 203-345-4800 to schedule an appointment. The Bluefish Gear Shop, perfect gifts for all ages and all sizes. Located at the ballpark at Harbor Yard, 500 Main Street, Bridgeport, Connecticut.
At Miller Lite, we believe if you're not choosing a light beer with more taste, you need to man up, not man down. Because up is way better than down. You don't tell someone sad to cheer down. What's down, dog? A steamy pile and you just stepped in it. Your girlfriend's not wearing a push-down bra. It's called gravity, Isaac Nitwit. Can I be down front with you? All this down talk is bringing me down. So don't man down, man up, and choose a light beer with more taste. Triple hops brewed Miller Lite. Taste greatness. Miller Brewing Company, Milwaukee, Wisconsin. Great beer, great responsibility.
Back to BridgeportBluefish.com. Perry Miles with you. It is the top of the ninth inning. Willis Otañez digs in. He has been the big bat in the lineup. One of them is the pitch is rocked foul down the right side, 0-1. Otañez, Lopez, Simmons. 4, 5, and 6 due up. Bluefish postgame show is coming up following the conclusion of the ball game. Scores and summaries from around the Atlantic League and also the big leagues. The 0-1 floater outside, 1-1. We have not heard too much from the River Sharks mascot. A big nose pointed at the nostril. The next toss is low. 2-1. It's almost like a pyramid nose, the way that a shark is. Nobody wants to be swimming next to a shark. But everybody seems to want to get right next to Finley, the mascot. The 2-1 is sent in the air to left center field. It goes back and sails over the head of the corner outfielder, Chris Walker. Otani is going for two. The throw goes well off the second base bag. It is a double for Willis Otañez to lead off the ninth inning. He has two hits on the day. Bernard Jones, the next pitch, floats outside, 1-0. As far as we can tell. Two hits for Rogers, two hits for Otañez, two hits for Boyer. Lopez and Jones, the only ones left out. The pitch is roped into right center field, angling over, diving. Did he make the catch? No, he did not. Otañez rounds third. He's coming to the plate. It's an RBI double for Lopez. That was almost one of the best plays of the year, and it could have easily hurt Gorecki as he is bent over with his knees trying to figure out how he did not catch that baseball. It's an RBI double for Luis Lopez, and the Bluefish extend the lead. It's 10-3. The left-hander stares in. The next pitch from Hauser is a line drive, sinking for a base hit as it flattens out, and Lopez is not even going to bother to score, especially with the way that it is right now. 10-3 ball game.
Number 8, Brad Boyer.
Brad Boyer digs in. So no RBI for Simmons, but he gets on base for the third time tonight. Two base hits and a hit by pitch for Simmons. Runners to the corners, nobody out. And there is bullpen activity for Camden. They are just not retiring the Bluefish right now. The first pitch swerves to the inside and misses the corner. 1-0. Down the right field line. Might be Josh Walters. The pitch is another line drive base hit into right field. The Bluefish hit parade continues. 4 straight hits to lead off, and a run comes home. It is 11-3. When Otañez and Lopez get to the plate in the same inning, that's a pretty good sign for the Bluefish. Those two players do not have the most speed on the team. They probably are the two tortoises on the team, but they hit well, and they produce runs. Otañez did an RBI double, and James Hauser has already given up 2 runs on 4 hits with nobody retired.
Bluefish have not scored this many runs in a long time. Last time that the Bluefish scored 11 runs as the first pitch over the middle of the plate for a strike going one, you'd have to go back to July the 16th. Today's September the 7th, almost 2 months. Next pitch is inside, one ball, one strike, where the Bluefish scored 18 runs at York. They've only scored 11 runs once in the second half. Now make it twice. Fastball outside. Two balls and one strike. The next delivery is swung on and served down the left field line as it heads towards the corner, but that ball angles foul. Two balls and two strikes. Figueroa hoping for a home run. The hits have been devastating and the pile driving has been more than sufficient for the Bluefish. The 2-2 on the outside corner, strike three. Luis Figueroa knew it. He goes down staring. He is 1-for-5 tonight. Let's take a quick look at the box score. Two hits, two runs for Rogers. RBI for him. Jones a run. Hit and two runs for Redmond. Two hits, two runs, four ribbies for Otañez. He extends his on-base streak to 14 in a row. Lopez, a hit, two runs, and an RBI. Simmons, two hits, a run, three ribbies. He's reached base three times. The one-out delivery. Low, maybe, outside. One ball and no strikes. Boyer, three hits and a run with a ribby. Figueroa hit. Flores with a hit. The 1-0 dances to the inside corner. Strike one. One ball, one strike to Flores. Flores has reached twice. Not been a productive day for the Camden bullpen. The 1-1. Another dancing changeup. One ball and two strikes. Hauser is not throwing with great amount of velocity from this angle. It seems to be floating at the plate and the Bluefish are hammering him. 1-2. Long fly ball foul down the left field line, out of play. One ball and two strikes. Campbell's Field, the site. Bridgeport Bluefish Baseball. Southpaw waits, he delivers, 1-2, grounded to third, gobbled up by Feliz, the throw to second is one, on to first, double play. That retires the side. The Bluefish score two runs on four base hits. That's probably the last time the Bluefish are going to be coming up to bat in this game, as the Bluefish are leading 11-3 at the end of 8.5. Stay tuned. You're listening to Bluefish Baseball on BridgeportBluefish.com. We'll be right back.
Why do we love baseball? Is it the uniforms, the pace of the game, the mascots? Could be. Or could it be that what we really love is that baseball reminds us how we can all come out ahead when we work together, just like a good team? At Prudential Annuities, we understand that when everyone works together, good things can happen. That's why each year, we uphold a commitment to helping charitable causes in our community, by pitching in financial resources and by enabling Prudential Annuities employees to help others through volunteer work. From conducting mentoring programs and helping homeless shelters to supporting health awareness and food banks, Prudential Annuities is more than a big company in Fairfield County. We're a big part of the community too. Prudential Annuities, going to bat for the community.
The Prudential Insurance Company of America, Newark, New Jersey, and its affiliates. Prudential Annuities is a business of Prudential Financial Inc.
This is Terry McGriff, pitching coach for the Bridgeport Bluefish, and you listen to Perry Miles on the Bluefish broadcast.
Hey kids, it's not too late to join BB and all of his friends by becoming a member of the Bluefish Snappers Club.
The Snappers Club is the newest club for all the biggest or littlest Bluefish fans. As a member of the Snappers Club, you'll not only get free entrance on Snappers Club Day, but you'll also get a membership card to show all of your friends, plus a special t-shirt that will tell everyone you're a member of the club. After each Sunday home game, Baseball Bunch members will also be invited onto the field to run the bases, just like the Bluefish do. You'll even receive a newsletter that will fill you in on all of your favorite Bluefish players, along with all the news that BB Snappers Club has to offer. To join the coolest club around, call 203-345-4800 or go to bridgeportbluefish.com/kids/snappers to become a member of BB's Snappers Club.
Hey Bluefish fans, have you heard about the clubhouse? Conveniently located in Fairfield, it has an unparalleled team of baseball and softball instructors offering private instruction, camps, team training, rentals, and best of all, the chance to learn from an all-pro team including Mike Porzio, former MLB pitcher, and the Bluefish's very own Willie Upshaw. Open 7 days a week. Stop in and meet our team or call us 203-292-8700 and visit us at the web, theclubhouseCT.com, and get the Major League experience.
The expectation for the River Sharks was to send Pedro Feliz, Raul Padron, and Eduardo Perez to the dish. They have made a change as the pinch hitter in this ball game is Juan Martinez. Right-handed batter, Feliz 0-for-3 with an RBI tonight, followed by what's expected to be Raul Padron and Eduardo Perez. 4, 5, and 6. First pitch is on the outside corner. No balls and one strike. This call to the bullpen presented by Prudential Annuities. Prudential Annuities going to bat for our community. Wanel Mesa makes his Bluefish debut. The 0-1. Chopper right back to the mound. Snagged by Mesa. He throws to first in time. One away. Nice play by Mesa. No relationship with Jose Mesa, the longtime closer in big league baseball. He's reached as high as A baseball in his career and played for the North American Baseball League with McAllen last year. Did not play much of this season. The Bluefish were looking for pieces to put together. Patrick Bresnahan had surgery. Wanel Mesa, I believe, also had surgery last year, which is why he couldn't pitch much of this year. So he's making, or at least trying to make his comeback with the Bluefish, the one-out delivery. Fastball high, one ball and no strikes. There's some explosion on that heat. You can tell by the pop of the glove and how much it's darting away. Plenty of movement. Mesa drops the glove, lifts it back up, and fires again. Pitches grounded to first, flag down by Lopez. He scampers to the bag, two away. So Wanel Mesa with a three unassisted after Juan Martinez was retired. Springs Eduardo Perez could be the final batter of the ball game for the River Sharks. Bluefish down to the final out. 11 runs, 13 hits to 3 runs, 7 base hits and 1 error. Game about 3 hours in length to this point. The 2-out delivery. Fastball way inside, one ball and no strikes. The Bluefish and the River Sharks were scoreless for the first 3 innings. It's been all Bluefish since. The only discrepancy, the 3 runs scored by the River Sharks in the 6th. Center fielder, everyone's playing no doubles at this point. James Simmons is playing very deep, the 1-0 tucked inside, 2 balls and no strikes. Flores visits the mound. Talk to Wanel Mesa. Mesa, first appearance in 2012 anywhere. Professional baseball player since 2006, undrafted free agent, signed with the Washington Nationals. Single A Hagerstown was the highest he got. The next toss, fastball inside. 3 balls and no strikes. Best season came in rookie ball, 09 with Washington.
26 and a third innings pitched as the next toss is outside and high, ball four. Mesa struck out 31 batters and posted a 2.73 4-2 record during that stretch of time. So he walks Eduardo Perez as Alvin Colina digs in. Right now, Jake Igesti and Alvin Colina have two-hit nights. The two-out delivery from the right-hander Mesa. Glove towards the neck, the two-out pitch, fastball tucked to the inside corner, 0-1. Bluefish got some timely hitting. Pico, seven innings, gives up three runs. Should win you a ball game most of the time. Mesa's 0-1. Breaking ball just missed off the inside corner. One ball, one strike. Mesa in disbelief. Meanwhile, it was a rough day for Brian Corey. Eight runs, seven earned. Next toss, line drive, foul. Down the left field line. Watch out. One ball and two strikes. Two men out. We'll get to the Atlantic League scoreboard update for the post-game show on BridgeportBluefish.com. Juanel Mesa one pitch away from possibly getting into that. The 1-2 slider outside, two balls and two strikes. But it's good news right now for the Bluefish. Southern Maryland, though, just scored a run. 6-4 in the bottom of the eighth. That team does not quit. The 2-2, a high drive to right field. Going forward is Prentice Redmond. He settles underneath and makes the catch. The ball game is over, and the Bluefish have won by a score of 11-3 at Campbell's Field. The post-game show comes to you right after this on BridgeportBluefish.com.
At Miller Lite, we know there's only one thing baseball fans love as much as great Pilsner taste, and that's rooting for the home team. Because home is way better than away. Away is not where the heart is. Bringing away the bacon? Why? Bacon is delicious. Away is where you hang your hat? You should be hung up by your underpanties. So why root for the away team when you can root for the home team? With a great Pilsner taste of Miller Lite. Triple hops brewed Miller Lite. Taste greatness. Miller Brewing Company, Milwaukee, Wisconsin. Great beer, great responsibility.
Shark tooth, screwdriver, golf tee from the golf trip that you never went golfing on, grill fork, tuning fork, fork fork, drumsticks, a motel key. Let's not talk about the motel key. Needle nose pliers, a spark plug, a domino, a house key. There's lots of things you can use to open the new Miller Lite Punch Top Can, but you'll always get the same thing. A smooth pour with less glug. However you punch it, it's Miller time. Miller Brewing Company, Milwaukee, Wisconsin. Great beer, great responsibility. Shark tooth, screwdriver, skeleton key, golf tee from the golf trip that you never went golfing on, grill fork, tuning fork, fork fork, the lucky fishing lure you snagged Alan with. Sorry, Alan. Drumsticks. Chopsticks from the place you met that Dallas-based flight attendant. A motel key. Let's not talk about the motel key. A spark plug. A domino. A house key. How do these things make Miller Lite from a can even better? Find out May 2012. Miller Brewing Company, Milwaukee, Wisconsin. Great beer, great responsibility. Miller Lite wants you to win the greatest weekend that never happened. The ultimate Vegas weekend for you and a buddy. Just collect Miller Lite taste points for your chance to win one of 100 Vegas trips being given away this summer for the big weekend. So grab Miller Lite and seize the summer at tastepoints.com. It's that easy, and it never happened. It's Miller time. No purchase necessary. Open to legal U.S. residents 21 or older. Void in California and where prohibited. Sweepstakes begins 5/1/12 and ends 8/1/12. For details how to enter and complete official rules, go to tastepoints.com. Miller Brewing Company, Milwaukee, Wisconsin. Great beer, great responsibility.
Miller time. Don't check your wrist or follow up with your supervisor, because Miller time has nothing to do with when and everything to do with who.
What's up, Tommy?
Miller Lite is brewed for the guys you're proud to call your brothers, who'll always talk you out of getting that faux hawk and never talk. during your backswing. And when you've got your brothers and a light beer that tastes like a beer should, it's not just a good time, it's Miller time.
Great beer, great responsibility. Miller Brewing Company, Milwaukee, Wisconsin.
Shark tooth, screwdriver, golf tee from the golf trip that you never went golfing on, grill fork, tuning fork, fork fork, drumsticks, a motel key. Let's not talk about the motel key. Needle-nose pliers, a spark plug, a domino, a house key. There's lots of things you can use to open the new Miller Lite Punch Top can, but you'll always get the same thing, a smooth pour with less glug. However you punch it, it's Miller time. Miller Brewing Company, Milwaukee, Wisconsin. Great beer, great responsibility.
Why do we love baseball? Is it the uniforms, the pace of the game, the mascots? Could be. Or could it be that what we really love is that baseball reminds us how we can all come out ahead when we work together, just like a good team? At Prudential Annuities, we understand that when everyone works together, good things can happen. That's why each year, we uphold a commitment to helping charitable causes in our community by pitching in financial resources and by enabling Prudential Annuities employees to help others through volunteer work. From conducting mentoring programs and helping homeless shelters to supporting health awareness and food banks, Prudential Annuities is more than a big company in Fairfield County. We're a big part of the community, too. Prudential Annuities, going to bat for the community.
The Prudential Insurance Company of America, Newark, New Jersey, and its affiliates. Prudential Annuities is a business of Prudential Financial, Inc.
We welcome you back to the Bluefish Broadcast Network. Perry Miles with you. The postgame show is here. The Bluefish win by a score of 11-3 from Campbell's Field. Let's take a quick look at the how everything unfolded. A run scored on an error by the third baseman, Pedro Lopez, and you can hear the booms in the background. We're going to try to make this without as much natural sound as possible, but the Bluefish, they scored the run on the error. You can hear the booms in the background. Home run, three-run shot to make it 4-0. Grand slam by Willis Otañez in the fifth to make it 8-0. The River Sharks, RBI back-to-back doubles from Gorecki and Walker. RBI grounder by Pedro Feliz to make it 8-3. Run scored on a bases-loaded walk by Eddie Rogers, and then a double by Luis Lopez, an RBI. Brad Boyer with an RBI single, and that led the Bluefish to the victory tonight. The Bluefish win by a score of 11-3. Let's take a quick look at the box score for tonight's action on BridgeportBluefish.com. As you could see, the reflection, everything going in the background. Tonight was a great night for the Bluefish offense. You could hear the explosions out there. Kennard Jones with a run, 2 hits, 2 runs, and a ribby for Rogers. Redmond a hit, 2 runs. 2 hits, 2 runs, 4 ribbies. Otañez a hit, 2 runs. A ribby for Lopez. Simmons, 2 hits, a run, 3 ribbies. Boyer, 3 hits with a run and RBI. A hit from Figueroa and Flores, overall 11-13-0. 3-7-1 for Camden. Gorecki a hit and a run. Walker a hit and run, a ribby. Padron a hit. 2 hits for Colleen and Agusti. Nothing for the rest of the team except for Delwin Young with a run scored. Matt Pike improves to 3-8 on the year. 7 innings. 3 runs, 7 hits, 2 walk, 4 strikeout baseball, an inning from Jesse English, 2 strikeouts, 1 LMSA, an inning, and a walk. Brian Corey falls to 9-9, 4 2/3, 8 runs, 7 earned, 7 hits, 1 walk, and 1 strikeout. 1 3rd innings for Hernandez, as you can hear in the deep background what is going on. An inning and a third for Hernandez and a hit. Steely with an inning, Smith with an inning, a run, a hit, 3 walks, James Hauser an inning, 2 runs, 4 hits, and 1 strikeout on the day. The Bluefish win by a score of 11-3. When we come back on the Bluefish postgame show, we will finish it up with the rest of the scores from around the Atlantic League and the Big League. Stay tuned. You're listening to Bluefish Baseball on BridgeportBluefish.com.
The YP.com website is your local search engine. If you're looking for a good restaurant, it can help you find the right one nearby with ratings and reviews. Or if your car breaks down, you can use the YP app to find the closest repair shop. Or maybe you're just looking for something to do on a Friday night. Well, it has great local coupons for all sorts of things in your area. No matter what, when, or where, if you're looking for something, YP Local Search can help you find it. So go to YP.com or download the app to search local, find local, and save local.
The Gear Shop at the ballpark at Harbor Yard is your one-stop shop for everything Bluefish. Take a break from the action and check out all your Bluefish souvenir favorites. From men's and women's t-shirts and a wide selection of home, road, and other trendy hats, to Fear the Fin rally towels, team photos, and commemorative baseballs. The Gear Shop has it all. Don't forget about our kids' wear section, game-worn jerseys, even your own stuffed BB the Bluefish, and more. The Bluefish Gear Shop is located on the third base side of the concourse level at the ballpark at Harbor Yard and is open on game days. Come and browse all your favorite Bluefish apparel from an hour before the first pitch until the final out is made. Can't make it to the ballpark on game day but still want to support Fairfield County's only professional baseball team? Then check out the new Bluefish online store at bridgeportbluefish.com or call 203-345-4800 to schedule an appointment. The Bluefish Gear Shop. Perfect gifts for all ages and all sizes. Located at the ballpark at Harbor Yard, 500 Main Street, Bridgeport, Connecticut.
You know what sounds really great for lunch? Breakfast. And what would be awesome for dinner? Breakfast. See, there's no better choice for breakfast, lunch, or dinner than Chips. Chips Family Restaurants in Orange and Fairfield. Known far and wide for extreme acts of outrageous pancakery, Chips also has a lunch and dinner menu that'll have you ditching the drive-thru and saying bye-bye brown bag. A full lunch and dinner menu of outrageously delicious sandwiches, salads, steaks, reasonably priced. And, of course, Chips famous pancakes for any meal, any day. For breakfast, lunch, or dinner. Flip it to Chips on the Post Road in Orange and in Fairfield at the intersection of Black Rock Turnpike and Tunxas Hill Cutoff. Voted best in Connecticut by the readers of Connecticut Magazine for extreme acts of outrageous pancakery all day long.
Want to win a trip for two to see...
We welcome you back to the Bluefish Broadcast Network. Perry Miles with you. Final score, 11-3. In favor of Bridgeport's, the most runs that the Bluefish have scored, well, actually, since August the 10th, and they scored 11 against Camden. Before that, it was 18 runs on July the 16th. So I do apologize for that misstep, but the Bluefish win 11-3. Let's take a quick look at the Atlantic League scoreboard update, courtesy of PointStreak.com and AtlanticLeague.com. Right now, top of the ninth inning, York leads Southern Maryland 6-4. Sugarland on top of Long Island 3-0. Lancaster defeats Somerset 5-3. York Revolution hold on. The Bluefish 4.5 games behind Southern Maryland heading into tomorrow's play. ESPN.com for the latest updates. The Yankees take care of the Orioles by a score of 8-5. Atlanta 3, Mets nothing, Toronto 5, Boston 1. That in the top of the sixth. Texas and Tampa Bay knotted at 1 in the bottom of the 10th. Runners at first and second. Miami and Washington tied at 6 in the top of the 10th. Colorado and Philadelphia knotted at 2 in the bottom of the ninth. Top of the ninth from Cincinnati, 5-3. Houston on top of Cincinnati. Runner at first, Chicago Cubs all over the Pirates, 12-2 in the bottom of the eighth with a runner at first. Kansas City and the White Sox knotted at 5, runner at first. Cleveland, Minnesota tied at 4 in the top of the seventh. It's a early moment. Angels 1, Tigers nothing, bottom of the first. Arizona and San Diego scoreless in the bottom of the first. Runners at first and second. Oakland and Seattle 1-0. A's on top of the Mariners, bottom of the first. Dodgers and Giants top of the first inning. From San Francisco and Milwaukee and St. Louis is yet to take place. It's possibly facing some rain. In women's tennis, Azarenka versus Serena Williams in the finals of the U.S. Open. Last but not least, panel vacates the bounty players' bans, which includes Jonathan Vilma, as it's a big, it's a changing event. Clemens solid in his second outing with the skiers, 4 2/3 frames of scoreless baseball. We thank you for tuning into the Bluefish Broadcast Network. For more details on the Bluefish Broadcast, you can go to the website, bridgeportbluefish.com. You can send me an email, perrym86 at gmail.com. Or you can follow me on Twitter, just me, P. Miles. Just me, P. Miles. The final score, the Bluefish 11 and the River Sharks 3. The Bluefish improved to 26-27, 57-66 overall, 23-31 for the River Sharks, 57-66 for Camden overall. The Bluefish will send left-handed pitcher Paul Seguero to the hill. 21 starts, 3 complete games, 10-5, 2-5-6 against, to be announced because of Eddie Camacho's calf injury, and the Bluefish will not be facing Keith Weezer either due to the elbow issues. Saturday, 5:35 first pitch from Campbell's Field
on BridgeportBluefish.com. 5:15 for the pregame show on BridgeportBluefish.com. Thank you for tuning in. The Bluefish improved to 29-34 on the road. They are 4-3 in the month of September, 57-66 overall. They are 10-6 against Camden this year, and the Bluefish are also 5-2 at Campbell's. They are actually 5-2 at Campbell's Field now. The final score: the Bluefish 11 and the River Sharks 3. The Bluefish improved to 10-7 against the River Sharks in 2012. For Perry Miles, have a wonderful night. We'll see you at 5:15 tomorrow afternoon. Ta-da for now, and we'll see you later.